Now that's a Lucky Pacino certified.
Yeah, man. So YouTube is YouTube.
We don't know what happened.
YouTube won't function. Are we sitting up just running out?
Yeah, you're listening. You're talking, and I'm like listening, paying attention.
And I'm looking like, because I was like, something ain't right about this chat. It's just
no one's saying not anything.
And I was looking like, am I finishing this? Somebody said he must want to finish this sandwich. I'm like, man, I haven't even finished. I haven't even ate that fucking sandwich. It's still sitting there, y'all. Look, it was weird because we sit up playing the video and we're just going with the shit and everything just shut down. No internet connection, no nothing, because me and her was still talking.
Right.
Y'all went to the friend of course, yeah. So what it was is we was going to go get the information and show y'all the, we was doing the funeral home information for the one in Alexandria. That's what we was doing. And then we went directly to the information about the funeral. Let's fucking cry. I ain't never seen no shit like that happen. That was some power panel bullshit, wasn't it? We know Denise did
never
that.
Never saw that before.
We know Lucky did that shit on purpose. We did that. Look, we apologize for the inconvenience, ladies and gentlemen. But we are back. What's up, Angel? What's up, Catrice? Kim? I'm saying we need 20 people, 20, 25 people back in here. I don't know what happened, Lonnie. It just, everything just went out. It wasn't the internet. It just, they shut it down. I think we're doing too much. I really believe that.
I don't know what happened, Lonnie. It just, everything just went out. Is that me or you? That's you?
I brought my chat up on my phone. I have a guy here that sounds just like you.
Yo, all right, so we're back again. Can we get 20? Come on in, fam. We need 1,000 people. Come on in, fam. All right, we wait till about 20 people get in, at least 20. Yeah, she's self-dropping too much information.
In the meantime, I would like to ask everyone a question on what they think about the boyfriend being the suspect number one.
Now, yeah, Jolie had a boyfriend, an ex-boyfriend, I might add. He's the suspect, number one, 17-year-old. And allegedly, they said he assaulted her, but they never reported the assault, which lets you know.
Allegedly.
So what happened is, it seemed like they're very irresponsible parents. They let their daughter get beat up, and they don't call the police, number one. Number two, she had an abusive boyfriend, and they didn't report the abuse. Number two. Number three, the boy is also in juvenile on unrelated charges, by the way. I'm pretty sure they know what type of shit he be on anyway.
But do we know when he went in?
We don't know when he went in, but we know in a 30-minute interview, they mentioned him being in jail. Now, on the other hand, you can insinuate the call being the mom or the boyfriend of the girl, because they were not specific in their, well, not there, but in his explanation, it was not specific. So, but we'll go with the fact that it's the next boyfriend of the girl, which is even worse, because like, you should know these things. But then they said he's not ruled a suspect because he's not dark skinned, he's light skinned. But then he said, let's just still hope the police don't rule him out because maybe he knows something about what happened with her. I'm like, dude, he's in jail. What are you saying? He sent a kite on the street? Yeah, I mean, that's possible, but come on, bro. If that's the case, How you, what you gonna charge him with setting up a contract? If they paid nobody in jail. Now, if he knows something, I understand you might wanna get some information. We're not gonna wait for 20, let's roll. So what we were doing, where we left off at? We was looking for.
We left off where you were just about to show the video.
I went to my. What was it?
You went to the funeral home.
Get in there, boy. Let's see. We're gonna share. Let's share. No, I don't want to share yet. Let me go to my.
Well, Catrice, I agree that he should be a suspect if he wasn't in jail. If he was in jail, I don't understand how he could be a suspect. Because they were talking about him being in jail at the, you know, the day after, whenever they did that interview.
Right. All right, so we sharing the screen again. All right, this is what we want to show y'all. This is, because this is where we went. We was right here. All right, now I gotta keep my eye out on the screen and make sure we still up, yo.
I'll check it too. I'll make sure that the live button on the top doesn't change. Yeah, it's
clear. Oh, wait, let's scroll this down.
That's what's crazy.
So this is one of the obituaries on it's on three sites. There's one for NJ Ford in Memphis. There's one for another service in Alexandria, which is this one. And this is the obituary, of course. And we talked about her. Why, how did they know that she died on the 26th? You know what I'm saying? Of course, it's the first and last name, address of Alexandria. All right. Now, let me see. I'm going to show y'all something, though. Oh, yeah. I meant to show y'all that this is the funeral arrangements. Let me zoom in right here. The funeral arrangements.
Actually, it's a memorial service.
A memorial service. I gotta stop saying it.
That's because that guy wrote that.
Yeah, he wrote that. It's kind of hard to get out your head when he wrote it. Hey, yo, don't you touch that sandwich in there. All right, so look. I'll touch that sandwich. No, the idea. I'm glad you didn't see it. Just act like you don't see it. I'm just letting you know. Don't act like you don't see it. All right, so look, memorial services. Or would be on February the 1st at this church in Springfield, Virginia. You said we were supposed to find out how far Springfield.
I looked it up. It's about like 15 to 20 minutes driving.
Okay, it's nowhere then.
It's not really that far, but.
I know Memphis is about 20 miles at least, 15 at the most, maybe.
So
what would they have anything to do with Memphis is beyond me, but.
But why would they have one in Alexandria and Springfield?
Yeah, like, what's the point? You know what I mean? Did they change their mind?
I don't know. But
all I know is they posted this yesterday. And I have a video where I went to the friend of a home and he said, because I think that was up before that, about 2 days ago.
I found it.
You found it 2 days ago, 3 days ago?
No, day before yesterday, I think. Wait, or was it yesterday? I found it yesterday, but who knows how long it had been up there. It probably was posted 2 days ago.
Right.
That's the thing. Whoever posted it, based off of the time, it was probably early sometime yesterday. Now, these ones were posted definitely after that. The memorial service was posted later on.
Right. So there's also a memorial service for this funeral home as well, Cunningham Church. It says Cameron Street, Alexandria, Virginia.
Mm-hmm.
There's another church, but I don't know if it's the same place, but this Woodbridge is another one. But this is the one. You know what I'm saying? This is the number and their Facebook page or whatnot. So that's another place. It's all three of these places or whatever. Who knows which one? But but I just thought it was kind of funny that you see that. And I'm going to show you something else, right? While we at it. Right? So the legacy account and the commercial appeal in Memphis.
That's new.
Yeah, this is the one. This is the one I found that's in Memphis. Said in Memphis. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Now the way it's spelled is that Jolie? Okay,
that's right.
That's not. So 16 of Memphis died January 26th, and that's the funeral home right here.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let me know if y'all see that or not.
Hi, Nicola.
Hey, Nicola. What's up, Sky?
Oh, it's Sky.
Yeah, we back. We back for
everybody. Hey, Sharon, Angel, everybody.
Right. Yeah. So what we're gonna do is, without further ado, we're going back to the video that we was playing before we was kicked off. Are we still on air? You gotta make sure.
Yeah, we're live. We're live.
So her body's in Memphis. Okay, we're gonna play what was said. That way we.
So she said, someone in the chat just said, so Huggy, her body is in Memphis. I mean, is her body in Memphis?
Nah, there's no guarantee that that's the case. So when I talked to the funeral home guy, he said that there's nothing final yet. He said it hasn't been, you know, it's not permanent yet, but he got it, you know, jotted down or set up for a funeral.
Well, what does it say? Oh, he does. Okay. What's it say on the actual site? Does it say funeral?
The site just says, you know, it says obituary, and it's got their particular funeral, you know, funeral home, which is NJ4 and Sons. If you go back, the legacy account also says that, and it's got this information. You know? Jolie Musa, you see that?
Yep.
And if there's an obituary, it's saying that she was a resident here. Which that don't make sense. Because the mom herself, if y'all are behind, this is a part two. If you weren't here in part one, if you weren't at the beginning, we're going to clear this up. The mom is not from Memphis, Tennessee. The mom is from Colorado Springs, Colorado. She's from Virginia. She was married to the guy, Musa, the guy, is it Cheryl? Sherry? Him? Siri?
Cyrilli?
They were married. We have records of all of that. They were married from 2001 to 2009.
Uh-huh.
Apparently they did get divorced in 2009.
Uh-huh.
She moved to Colorado Springs, Colorado.
Yep, with the rest of her family.
The rest of her family, because that's where she's from.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So she's not from Memphis. So when we had the news article, I mean, I'm gonna need for y'all to catch up. If y'all catch up, we're gonna keep it going, because you know, it's a lot. I know a Jasmine boy. I need to look that person up. That's crazy. I'm bothered by that. I'll check that out later. But anyway, as you can see here, send flowers. If I want to send some flowers, of course. As you can see, Jolie Musa.
Did anybody leave condolences yet? Because yesterday there wasn't any. You know, they could sign a guest book, leave condolences, stuff like that. Go back.
Let's go back.
Where it says sign guest book.
Nothing.
View guest book right there. View guest book. Bottom. Right there.
Guest book.
Up.
Okay, there we go. Nothing. Because, see, nobody realizes what's going on. Like I said, when I saw on the Fox 13 Memphis, the local Memphis, on the Facebook post, people were just asleep. They were just saying, you know, anything. They're not paying attention to the fact that how is her mom from here? You watched the 30-minute interview. They said the mom's from Texas. And she's not even from Texas. She lives in Texas with her new husband.
Oh, yeah, Sherrod. Yeah, I mentioned it in mine, too.
And yeah. The husband ain't even from Texas.
No, he's from Detroit. No one's from Memphis.
Nobody's from Memphis or Texas, but by the way. So, let's get to the video, because I also want to point out a few things. So, give me a second here. Let's see. Boom, boom. I don't want to play. I don't need to be about right there. Let's go back.
We're outside of.
Am I still live? I got a double check. Okay.
It says live. Yeah.
I know. Memphis, Tennessee. And we're about to do. We're about to do some investigating here because now we're learning that Joey Finley most likely will be here because now the mother is portrayed, or at least just to so say the safer assumption. She's allegedly from Memphis, Tennessee. We're gonna get into the facts of the memorial that's set up in Springfield, Virginia. There's another funeral that has some type of memorial. We're gonna get deep into that. Right now, what we wanna do is we wanna get to the bottom of this. So take a walk with me and take a ride. Here we go. Let's make a move real quick, y'all.
Now, what I want to do is the sound is a little bit messed up in the very beginning, then you can eventually hear us speak. So I'm going to kind of run y'all through of what I was saying or not. I have a memorial service for Jody. He said earlier it wasn't completed.
No, it's still pending.
Everything is still pending on the arrangements.
Hopefully
we'll know something by tomorrow. I am going to call his ass because it's about 4 o'clock. I'm going to call him at 4 o'clock, same time I did today.
When I was looking up the information about it, and I was like, yeah, I was like, I didn't know she had family.
Yeah, because I was about to say
she had family.
Yes, I said, I didn't know she had family here in Memphis. And he laughed.
Then I was like,
oh. Because
I at least want to have my family, pay off space. Yeah, since we called her.
I think that's in Alexandria, Virginia.
Oh, I see.
And then she saw one last night that's in Springfield, Virginia.
Okay.
So can they have three different? Can you have three different? Yeah, that'd be weird. So I do know two of them.
Oh, okay.
So I saw it here and I was just talking.
Why you don't know if it's concrete now? If you know, if you're gonna know tomorrow, you should know today, because you didn't put it up yesterday. You didn't put it up today. You put, well, technically it was yesterday. You didn't put it up Tuesday. You put it up Monday. Now you said, well, take that back. How long has it been up, Krisha?
The 2 days.
Or 2 days?
No, I think it was put up early yesterday sometime, so.
Okay, okay.
But if it hasn't been finalized, why the hell are they posting it online?
Exactly. It's like he keeps me in the dark, so when I call tomorrow, it's going to be a totally different story. Most likely, what they might end up doing is they're going to come up with some kind of way to make this funeral a closed casket, or a possibility where they just have a memorial service and it's just going to be a cremated situation where it's just like ashes or whatever. They're going to come up with something. They're going to do something, because whatever the fuck he knows it. He already knows it. But I just was like, I don't want to make him uncomfortable. I want to make it seem like, because I ain't going to lie, if it's a funeral here, I'm going. I'm gonna be.
You're gonna go?
Yeah, I'm going. And I'm recording. I don't give a fuck what they, I don't care if they like it. I'm going.
The mama, I wanna see the mama, the sister, the dad.
Oh, yeah, I'm gonna see everybody. Yeah, I think they better not have no friend. I'm Huggy showing up. Homeboy said, he said, come on, y'all. Let me try to get to my car.
Because it'll be open to the public, right?
He said what else?
It'll be open to the public, right?
Yeah, it will, hopefully.
Hey, Kels.
I hope it'll be open to the public.
I would imagine.
You know what I mean? When Reggie Wright got caught, I don't know. Yeah, a lot of people don't know Reggie Wright is responsible for security the night Pac got shot in Las Vegas. The Right Way Security, he owned that company. And long story short, he's responsible for possibly setting up the hit that got Tupac shot that night. So he had got caught up in a lot of shit recently where he's tied into a lot of gang activity, drugs from connected from here to California. He caught some charges here. I went to that court date. I need to know if he's going to be there, what's going on.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm serious as hell. And shout out to Jay Nix. He got a Death Row channel where he covers nothing but Tupac information, Death Row information. He pulls up like classic interviews that nobody's never heard. Real talk.
Another thing about that website, and what you should ask him tomorrow when you call in, is how, where'd they get that date of death from?
Oh yeah, I'm digging into him when I call him tomorrow.
Yeah, because who said she died that day? If she was found at the park right around the corner from her house, it would be more likely that she was killed that same day or next day in that same area, not 2 weeks later.
Right, and you gotta get an official date of death, or you just tell the people the 26th.
Right,
because if they're doing an autopsy, I don't know nothing officially anyway.
There is no results yet.
So he said call tomorrow. He said nothing's concrete about that. So for right now, he said that it's pending. If she has the service here or not, which I find weird that you have services pending in the city that you claim to be from. If they're in Virginia, if they live in Virginia, I think that that will be where they be buried, or that's where they are buried. If you're from, I didn't think it'd be where the parents is from, not where the girl is from, unless she's from you. But I had no knowledge that the girl, nobody mentions Memphis, Tennessee at all. And as you can see here, this is NJ for the home. The sign here. What are we gonna do? We're gonna pull off so I can show you.
The car sounds so quiet, don't it?
That's McCormick Sunrise Day School. It's in the heart of South Memphis, or Riverside, I might add. Funeral home.
Is that a popular funeral home?
And,
oh, yes, it is. It's been there since the 1920s.
You know, thank God, because I at least wanted to not have this live, because I didn't want it to be janky and, you know, messed up. So hopefully I got the audio, but I didn't want to have the camera out. But I did speak with the guy. I hope I picked up the audio where it did say that it was pending. Nothing is concrete yet. So apparently there have been talks about the funeral being here in Memphis, which I don't understand why. You have memorial. And keep in mind, memorial arrangements is one thing, but they're not funeral arrangements. They have memorial arrangements in two cities in Virginia, one in Alexandria and one in Springfield. Now, the one announced by the mom on her Facebook page was tagged with her name in Springfield. The one that has Cumber something, I forgot it. It's in my iPad. Let me put my iPad.
Not at the light. I ain't no damn fool, y'all.
Yeah. Yep, all my pictures. This light is green. Give me a second, y'all.
Hi, lady.
Hello. All right, come on. Come on, car. Come on.
He says, I'm in NC, but my family has fought for our family all the way in Maryland.
Oh, it's on the NC, but my family has plots for our family all the way in Maryland. What you mean by that?
Yeah, I don't understand.
I'm lost. Nicole, can you repeat that? I don't understand what you mean.
Don't dig into a few things.
Hey, what's up, Lee? What's up, Kales? What's up, King? Sky, Cherry. I saw a lovely one. What's up, lovely one? Earlier. Lonnie, we back.
Hey, guys, you can see here.
What's up? Capo.
Here we go.
Katrina.
Obituary. Bam.
They're okay. Are they saying that they're just saying that they might have family members, even though that they are from, that they have, that they're buried in another state? But the thing is, they said on this obituary information that Jolie is a resident of Memphis, Tennessee.
What it said, you see it? 16 of Memphis, died January 26, 2008, and this is the funeral home I went to, right there. It's right here in my sitting. She sent it to me. She said, you're not gonna believe this. And she sent it. I said, what? The first thing that came to my mind is like, damn, the girl ain't even from Virginia. She's from here. And then we said, no, wait a minute. And then we looked up a lot of stuff. And I remembered, I said, didn't you say it's Colorado? And then I looked deep into that and I was like, oh, okay, so mom is full of shit.
Oh, she's saying that her family passes, no matter where they are from, is spots already paid for in Maryland. Okay, I could see that, but what other family members? Because there's no there would have to be some family member that we could find.
She allegedly didn't have custody of them, according to what the father said.
Right.
The kids
and
were
the father
all
has no
with him
back in Memphis at all.
At all. All his roots are in Virginia.
He wasn't even born. I can't even find a record of him being born here. I could only find a record of his marriage. So I don't even think that he grew up in the United States.
I ain't gonna lie to you. I think about when Nicole, because there's another girl named Nicole Musa. I'm gonna probably talk to her tomorrow again. She married a guy that was Muslim, that was from he was African. She married him, and he needed a green card. He got here by way of marriage. Y'all know that's the old game that plays out. She got him here. They got married. They was together for a while, and the relationship got sour. She got tired of it. She got out the marriage and she left. She left him eventually. You know what I mean? She lived in North Carolina too. And what I noticed is in these areas on the East Coast, even in the southern part of the East Coast, they have a lot of immigrants, Africans, different people, some people from Somalia, all these different places. So, like I said,
that's cool, Nicola. I don't think that I don't know in this case, because I don't even know that she's going to be buried in Memphis.
Yeah, because that don't make sense, because if the dad had the custody, wouldn't it necessarily mean that if they were born in Virginia, that they would be raised in Virginia, that they would be buried in Virginia? Colorado Springs, Colorado, if anything. You know?
Right. Because that's where I would imagine.
Yeah, I mean.
Now, I don't know if this theory is true or not. I know that it was put up in like a Mike Larry's video recently, that he was talking to a lady on there, and she said that she was thinking that it was an honor killing if they are Muslim, and by one of the, you know, the dad or the family member, that for her, like, trying to sneak out and see boys or whatever.
Well, that's possible, but she has to be a Muslim first.
Or the dad is. We don't know how long they've been staying with the dad.
Well, yeah, that too. But y'all got to remember, the dad said he just flew in. The mom just said she flew in. And what's pissing me off, not pissing them off, but the idea pissing me off that you say the dad is responsible. But remember, he just flew in, and so did the mom.
And then she's making a good point. Okay, because Teresa asked a question. She said, so has anyone found out if they found the guy who used a 13-year-old phone to call Jolie the day she went missing? That's a very good question, considering the fact that they're trying to blame a kid who does not match the age, description, height, or anything else of who they're claiming to be a suspect and who was incarcerated at the time. So,
yeah, the 17-year-old boy is light-skinned, and the father said, and I quote, he doesn't fit the description, he's light-skinned, but still don't rule him out because he probably had something to do with it. But keep in mind, and the boy, they can't even make up how old the boy is, if he's 12 or 13. But my thing is, why isn't the 12 or 13-year-old boy the person of interest?
Exactly, the invisible uncle. Thank you, Lonnie. I've been saying that. Where's uncle?
The invisible uncle. But we could start with the guy, not guy, but the boy that called her. You can't trace that number. How do y'all even know he's 12 or 13? Did you talk to him?
Yes, they did. They talked to him on the news. You want to watch it?
Oh, they have? I didn't know. Y'all seen it. They seen that. They had his black, had his back turned with a faded ass shirt. I'm like, nigga, you got a new phone, and you ain't got you can't put a new shirt on.
Yep. So they interviewed him. But he's saying that some man, not teenager, but a man, borrowed his phone on the basketball court. Do you realize that the basketball court and where she was found are steps apart?
Yes.
I could throw a rock from the basketball court and it would hit the area where she was found.
I tell you one thing, ain't nobody playing basketball in 33-degree weather. and why would they, like, come on, they couldn't think of a better story to say. They couldn't say the mall, they couldn't say the corner store, they couldn't say, because remember you mentioned something about the bank. She didn't
go to
the
bank right there. There's a gas station right there. There's, you know, and here's the thing. If the guy used the phone at the basketball court, that means that she wasn't picked up. That means that she walked to the park. That means that gas station had to have picked her up on surveillance, because she literally had to have walked past. Once you turn, you have to turn down this one street to get to that park. She had to pass a bank and a gas station. They both had cameras. Where is that surveillance at? How many times have we seen surveillance of, you know, somebody getting robbed or trying to rob somebody at an ATM. Millions of times, right? Really? They have cameras all the time at these banks and at these gas stations. Always. Where is the surveillance of her walking past? It doesn't make any sense because it's not real as far as the story goes. Now, the girl might be dead. It might be an old story. I don't know. But what I do know is the story that they gave us is bullshit.
Yeah. It's kind of like when you first heard 9/11, when you listen to everything, it doesn't make sense. But you don't really question it because you think, well, damn, everything is crumbled. We got ground zero. We got dead bodies. We got people jumping out the buildings. And you think, like, damn, terror, 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 fear, fear, fear. And you don't get a chance to critically think. So now we got to critically think before we even assume something is real.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? So now, because I ain't going to lie, that Kaniga shit had me, I put my hands down. Like, I got slapped the fuck up, and I thought this was real. And then I thought, like, wait a minute. That's not even her walking around. I look like CGI. And I was looking like, you could obviously see that she looked transparent and see-through and everything.
Yeah. Be well driven. I don't know if she's dead. She might be dead. She might be back wherever she came from. I don't know. But that's the thing. With the PSYOPs, I mean, it could be a story. Let's say the story. Now, remember, there was a news, that Peggy Fox, she slipped up on one of the news stories, and she said the date of June the 12th, January. She said like Friday, June the 12th. So maybe that wasn't a slip up. Maybe it really did happen.
Was it the 13th? But the 13th wasn't a Friday. Is that correct?
Well, she didn't say the day of the week. I have to go back. I put it in my video, I believe. I did. In one of the videos, because I'm like, come. No. I haven't made that video.
And look. And if y'all haven't seen her last two lives, go to Miss Crenshaw's page. Subscribe to Miss Crenshaw's page. She has two live videos. And you need to go catch up over there before you catch up over here. So you got to catch up on a lot of information she put out the last two videos.
Yeah, I you know what? I did play a clip of it. It's just a clip where she's saying, I can play the clip right now so everyone can hear it, because it's ridiculous. She literally says, the wrong day and the wrong date.
Right.
I was like, you have got to be kidding me. Let me see it. Can you hear?
Yeah, here.
And correct me if I'm wrong, the FBI was involved in her disappearance as well.
The FBI was not involved in the beginning. Parents say they called police that Saturday night, July 12th. And it wasn't
until... You hear that?
Right, July 12th.
That Saturday night, July 12th. What?
Yeah.
What?
Right.
What, Peggy?
So what I'm going to do, so what we need to do now is we need to go through the July 12th. Missing. Because I'm saying the Amber Alert thing was weird. Like, no Amber Alert.
Oh, there was a. No, there wasn't. Let me see. No. What year? What year would that have been?
Yeah, she said July 12th. Are you asking me?
No, I'm trying to figure out. I'll find out to see when the last time there was a Saturday, July 12th. But she slipped up somewhere. Let's say even if it wasn't Saturday, even if it was, I don't think that. So that's always a possibility. My point in that is it's a possibility that they're lying about when this happened. They're lying about the fact that it happened at all. I also want to point out the fact that I can't be the only one that's noticed all of these things where teenagers are being found dead in parks. Blaze Bernstein, look up that story. It is ridiculous. It just happened. I'm talking about the other week. California, supposedly his body was found barely covered up, just like this girl, like by some leaves, and he was supposedly stabbed 20 times without a drop of blood in sight, and right. his and there was a school right there, there's a basketball court right there, and there's a park. I mean, there's no way it could have been, like, no dog smelled him, no nothing. Then look at the Delphi murders, which was less than a year ago. And same thing. Nobody saw anything. Nobody heard anything. That their house was less than a mile away. I don't know what it is. If it's just for, like, they're just aiming to get, like, you know, more security, and they don't want there to be no privacy outside whatsoever anywhere. If that's what this is about, or what? Who leaked this story? Nicola Coleman. The which one? Are you talking about the girl, the Jolie story? That one, the family.
Yeah, the family did. And Peggy Scott, aka Bruce Jenner Jr., came in and just she knew everything and just helped them out.
Oh, she knew more than they did.
She should have just been called directed by Peggy Fox.
Well, you know what? No, you're right. It basically did start by, you know, you could say that it started by Facebook, and I'll tell you why. I never in my life have seen an interview where the news reporter, a news reporter that has quite an extensive background, by the way, she didn't just start doing this. The news reporter goes into a home, uses her cell phone to conduct an interview, and the interview is filmed on Facebook Live.
All right.
That's how they did this interview.
I ain't never heard of a live interview with a phone.
They interviewed...
Unless it was over the phone, but not in person.
She recorded on Facebook. She was reading the Facebook Live comments. More shit.
It's a more professional way to do a Facebook Live. You can use an actual GoPro or some shit. You can actually do an actual camera and actually do the live feed from a laptop or something. You know? Yeah, and make it more HD-like, you know, more professional base.
I've never seen anything like that in my life, so I was just like, no, I've never, has anyone ever heard of an interview with a family in their home or really anywhere else where they...
I've seen coverage on the phone live. Like if there's a story on the scene, such and such is happening, is this a car on fire?
Oh, yeah, something happened.
I've never seen an interview with a family of a missing teen or a person in general. That don't even make sense.
And that's what I'm saying. Why would they do that?
You know what I mean? So, hold on, let's finish this up. Did I have anything else to say? I think it was a minute and a half.
To Eric? Damn. Now, my thing is, this is...
Lovely one. That's my lovely one. I shout you out. I said hi to you.
Hey, lovely one. Oh, she in the chat?
Yeah, look. She's right there.
I did say so. I did say lovely one. Did I not say? I thought I saw lovely one earlier.
It cut out on us.
Oh, you talking about the last one? It cut out again?
I don't know, but I... Oh,
okay.
But anyways, you know I love you.
Yeah. No, I said, I know lovely one. So I said, what's up, lovely one? See, she be tripping. But I thought she heard him. But let's finish this up real quick.
Funeral home.
I'm hungry as hell. It's 1:34.
The celebration funeral home. There's an obituary here. In Alexandria, Virginia, Cameron Street, 811. You know? So I think that's weird as well. This is what was posted with the mom's information. Springfield, Virginia, totally different place. And we're gonna talk about this being in Memphis, where they said that, you know, that she's from here. That team, come on, y'all, focus. The FBI has got involved in relatives and team in Memphis. All of a sudden, has seen their loved one. All right, this is an update, by the way. As you can see, Jolie's mom and are from Memphis, Tennessee. And Docker is supposed to be done. We're going to get into these Facebook pages. We need some help too, so.
Wait a minute. They said, what did it say, the first sentence?
Let me go back.
It said that they were looking for her in Memphis?
No, they didn't say looking for her in Memphis, though.
What it said, Jolie Musa, a 16-year-old girl, has been missing for more than 2 weeks.
Right, so the FBI has got involved.
Okay.
The relative
to the teen in Memphis are hoping someone has seen their loved one.
Loved one. Exactly. So.
All right, this is an update, by the way. As you can see, Jolie's mom and are from Memphis, Tennessee. And Dr. Ray is supposed to be on. We're going to get into his Facebook page. We need some help too, so. And shout out to Miss Crenshaw, but we both on this. So we'll be back. I'm going to add more to this video, just collecting and compiling everything. And we'll be back with more information.
What I was going to do is I was going to put that up. But then I was like, nah. Because everything, you know, now we saw the person of interest and.
Right.
That's how we got to this. Right
I
here.
I feel like the only reason why we brought him up is because we can't verify anything on him, because we cannot look up the arrest records or anything else of anyone that's a minor. I don't know any state that lets that, allows that to be public record. If you're a minor, they so it's almost like we're just stuck. We're just stuck, and we have to, like, people are, you know, most people don't do what I do and investigate absolutely everything and cross-reference everything everyone says. So, you know, a lot of people, that's how they just get, you know, you don't, you just trust what they say, and oh, you know, you're just happy that they actually made an arrest. But in reality, we don't know. We don't know that. We don't know that, because there's absolutely no way for us to verify it. We don't even know his name. Do we know his name?
Nah, I don't know his name at all. And if you notice, the patch website ain't even have no comments or nothing, but I figured since it's been up since, you know, yesterday, you would think people would start talking. And my thing about how they portray pictures is weird. You can find a better picture to put up than that.
Right?
Like, that's the best picture you could put up. It's weird, like why the tongue out picture, like, you know? I don't know.
Oh, so anyway. Oh, she said Lamar. Oh, go back to the chat. We looked him up too last time, Miss Sweet. Do you remember?
Yeah, we did. We did that already with the suspicious stuff. I think that's smoke and mirrors. I think a lot of that is set up. I'm writing that off. That's my personal opinion.
Why would they do that and then delete it?
You see what I'm saying? That's the thing. I think a lot of that is smoke and mirrors. I could tell by the way they were typing him. It looked like it's all rehearsed and reacted.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's weird. That shit was weird. Now, at the moment, I was thinking like, oh, that's bizarre. And then as I get deep into this, mom is lying about where she's from. She went on Facebook. And let's just backtrack a little bit. She is on Facebook saying she's from Memphis when she originally was not.
No, she wasn't.
You know what I mean? As we back here we go. You know what's funny about how she made her name? She put in parentheses Stewart as if she's married to a Stewart, but it's supposed to be the other way around.
No.
But I
Serita
guess
Hill is her name now, so it would be Serita Hill.
So I guess she put Stewart in parentheses. That's like the alternative, so people can still find you.
Yeah.
But as you can see, it says she's from Memphis, Tennessee. And Crenshaw, we don't have I wish we had the receipts. But once again, for the 20th time, if anybody got a screenshot of this woman's page before she changed it to Memphis, please, we need that. I don't even care if you make a video. We need that out there. I'm pretty sure somebody got it. Somebody got it. Cause somebody can't possibly be thinking like me and her, where we think like, oh, that didn't say Memphis at first. It did not, and she's not from here at all. I'm gonna backtrack on that a little bit, cause we pretty much done with that. We got the funeral arrangements out the way. This is her entire resume for hood ticket.
Right. It goes back far too. I mean, it goes back to like 2001.
2002. Yeah. Remington College.
Wait, isn't that when the girls were like born?
2001 they were born, yeah.
Yep.
So 2002, she's been doing security. She's been doing security for a while. She had 12 years experience. So as you can see, this is her rap sheet. Not rap sheet, but work history. Yeah, and where she went to school, Colorado Springs, Colorado. That's where she eventually left Virginia because her and her husband got divorced and she left and moved to Colorado Springs, Colorado. Now, somewhere in between there, Detroit or Texas, she met Mr. Hill, Eric Hill, the twin, because he also has a twin. See what I'm saying? I mean, one thing about it is that
there was an arrest person of interest. No,
they didn't arrest anybody. He's already in jail.
He's in juvenile.
He's a 17-year-old. He's in juvenile, and he's already in jail for something else that's unrelated to the case. He's a person of interest.
Same thing so like Daniel Nations with the Delphi murders. He wasn't arrested for killing those girls. He's already in custody in Colorado for something that has nothing to do with those murders. But it just makes people feel better when they say that someone, that the suspect is in custody. But when you've got to pay attention to the way that they word things.
And for the record, I just want people to stop jumping the gun and saying one thing. If you're going to blame the dad and assume that he did it, remember, he said he just flew in. The mom said the same thing.
Right.
They both weren't around. So how ironic they both show up. But somehow the man is all blamed. Remember, there was an uncle that was watching them. Nobody's blaming or even trying to figure out who is he.
Right. He is a person of interest is what they're saying. Yes. I don't know how really when he was in custody, but.
Yeah, he's a person of interest, but that's all. And you know, I'm going to tell you how, and Lisa Bonet, I want you to think about this for a moment. Why is the 12 or the 13-year-old boy a person of interest then? He should have been the first one questioned. But they only had him on the news. He wasn't a person of interest.
Right.
And it
was his phone that made the call. So how do we know that he just didn't make up the other guy at the basketball court?
Exactly. What if the 13-year-old boy didn't? What if he did kill him?
Right.
You know,
kids kill kids.
Really, I know 11-year-olds packing guns.
Right.
Yeah, they in New Orleans.
And she walked up to the park where he was on the basketball court.
She's saying he wasn't in custody. That is false.
Arrested on January what? Does that say one?
I'm assuming 11th or 21st. Is that what you're trying to say?
What date are you trying to say?
That's false. He was already in jail for something unrelated. They said that repeatedly. Like, if he's in jail for something unrelated, he's already in jail.
What's January 18th? Let's watch exactly what it is that he's...
Let's go see.
Watch CFC.
All right, check this out. Lisa Bonet, I'm going to make you a moderator. Post the link in the group, and we'll go directly there. Post us the link.
Moderators, real quick.
Post the link in the group. Copy and paste the link. It'll let you post it because you're a moderator. We're going directly there and we're going to verify this. Because I want
to. Exactly. Miss Sweet B, exactly.
We'll post it again because you couldn't post it. You weren't a moderator. You can post it now.
Yeah.
You can't post the website unless you're a moderator. Copy and paste it right now. We're going directly there. We're doing this.
Yeah,
live.
Go to share. Copy and then paste it.
Yeah.
Exactly, Miss Sweet B. That's a very good point, and I've always been
because that means is a contradiction in the story plot.
Right. Miss Sweet B. Because that makes so okay. Either one of two things. If the uncle was there, that's a problem. Because what the hell was he doing that he didn't even know that she wasn't there at all? And if he wasn't there, then why did they say that he was there babysitting? Why would he be babysitting girls that were going to spend the night somewhere else? The dad said that the girls told him, not his brother, him, that they were going to be, that they lied about spending the night. Actually, he said that the twin that's alive, like, lied to him too about what she was gonna, you know, where her sister, the whole thing, it just doesn't make any sense. Was there an uncle there babysitting her or not? Whose car was that in the driveway? You know, shit like that.
Right. And why that parking lot was so goddamn empty on the right?
That shit was weird. If you don't get that tile out your mouth, come here, come
here. No, man, I'm upset right now. Anyway. Yeah. So I'm going to leave y'all with this. Miss J All Day. Subscribe to Miss J All Day. This is a very detailed video. She goes in depth of the interview. Hold on. Hey, Ben. Now. Good boy. Yeah, so what happened is, in this, she goes through the interview thing. She really thoroughly breaks it down. She points out a few things I didn't catch, like, you know, it's a lot of stuff going on. It's a camera there. I just want to know what that camera is about. That's weird too. It looked like there's no furniture in the home. Everybody, if you haven't seen it, I'm gonna need for y'all to go check out the 30-minute video. But if you don't want to just go check out the 30-minute video, go check out Miss J All Day's video. And it's thoroughly, it's on point. You got screenshots, very important screenshots, by the way. That was a screenshot in here I want to share with y'all.
What?
Give me this.
Someone else said, and I haven't got a chance to go back and watch it yet, you know that interview that was done, another interview where it's just the mom and the sister sitting on a couch?
Yeah.
That they said that that's they the one where they meet someone. Someone said that, and there's a, I think they wrote it in one of my comments, that it looks like they could, you could see someone in the reflection of something that looks like it was jewelry.
What?
Here we go with this. Yeah, we'd have to go to the video. I got to go to my screenshots to see where exactly they told me that was.
Lisa, you didn't.
Because I was like,
you can't find a video. Anyway.
Where is she at?
You can find a video. Right, if you can find a video, post it in the chat room. That video you talking about where they need a knee. I think I saw it, but I don't know where to get it. I saw the video. I know you're talking about. But yeah, like this screenshot right here. Call me Peggy. I saw her this morning. Then call 911, not the reporter, and tell the police what you saw. She's the Fairfax County Police. I've already spoken with
Peggy,
them.
I'm sending you a text right now of this. Somebody told me. She says that she, when their mom and sister are sitting on the couch making their plea, and someone can be seen in the mirror behind them recording, but when they notice, they drop the camera down.
Yeah, you wanna play it, because that video is in here. She actually go through the whole video in here.
Oh really? Yeah, play it then.
I don't know if the song is gonna give me, because she got that reggae song, man. All right, so here we go. Once again,
that's not the
what?
That's not the same one. There's a different one where just the mom and the sister are sitting on the couch.
Yeah, but you showed me this screenshot, right? So that's not the video, right?
No, there's a different interview. I'll find it. There's a different interview with just the mom and the sister, not this whole family. Jolene Musa, you could say, put mom and sister.
I know what you're talking about too. It's like knee to knee.
They're like, yeah, they're sitting right next to each other.
There you go.
Right there.
Walk into the public. I'm gonna shut the
chat up. Walk into a public business and just say, I'm Jolene Musa and I need to call my mother. We're not worried about anybody but Jolene safety. I miss my baby. I love my baby. And I know that she is alive somewhere. And I need her to come home. It's been 5 days. And I can't get an Amber Alert. And I know this is not my daughter's personality. She's never late. I know these things about my child. I know my child. So please, I beg you,
Were they talking about on the glass?
Are they talking about the, let me see.
The reflection on the glass?
You don't need to stuff. And I need to call my mother. We're not worried about anybody but Joe Lee's safety. I miss my baby. I love my baby. And I know that she is alive somewhere. And I need her to come home. It's been 5 days. And I can't get an ember.
Are they talking about?
Oh, no. They said someone could be seen in the mirror behind them. So maybe it was the other one then, because there's no mirror behind them in this one. So okay. I don't know whichever video has a mirror behind them. Oh, but you know what? In that long interview, like this one, there is a time that they built it on the couch. It's like half an hour long that she's on Facebook Live.
I think I know what you're talking about, too. This right here.
Let me ask you this. Do you know, we know that she...
At the home here, right? On Friday.
Okay, my older twin sister, I'll be right back. Right. Yeah.
Those
nuts. Did she get into the car? And I, you don't know who. I mean, she was obviously communicating with someone.
Communicating with
someone that she didn't tell her.
Hold on, Lisa, back in the chat. It's a live video on Peggy's Facebook page. Yes, Peggy, you got all the vids. I'm gonna need for you to post it though.
Right, post a link.
Yeah, because I'm not looking for that man.
I'll look for it. This is a... Peggy Fox. What do you mean? She has her own. What does she mean that she has it? She on Facebook? You want me to go to her Facebook?
Oh, fuck it. Let's go to Peggy.
Well, I want to see the. Oh, whatever.
So. You're going to Peggy. Ooh, see? What the hell? A lot of you niggas chicks are like this a bit. See, people on Facebook ain't got no filter. You see that nasty shit? Goodness, no. Oh, my God.
I was like, what is that?
A woman looking like that, you know, ass kick. All right. And see, they doing a press conference. When there was a press conference, this like this shit like this is a dead giveaway. You know what I mean? Look, you're talking about personal interest. They ain't say somebody being charged.
Go to videos right there. I'm excited.
You put the chat up. Which
okay,
video?
So which video is it?
Is it this one? It might be that one. I mean, she ain't like fake. Which title, Lisa?
We are on her Facebook page. We are on her Facebook page.
DFC.
Oh, my goodness.
Come on, Lisa.
I guess go to Peggy Fox CFC on the top search for.
I'm gonna need for you to know which video. It was the title of which video. We got six video. We got
right. Peggy Fox 12 video. Facebook page.
What's up, Hebrew? What's up, Lee? I'm gonna speak to everybody while I wait on this.
Peggy Fox News. What is she? This is her news.
Oh wait. That's a thorough video. Which video?
Oh my goodness.
Lisa, I think it's a delay. She probably got a delay.
They're on the couch.
We just watched that.
We didn't see the one though with the couch with the mirror.
They probably used that camera to record that video. Yeah. The camera that was in the background.
Scroll down through these videos and let's see if we're missing something. What was the whole point of what was the video supposed to be about that she was telling us about anyways? Like, what was the, scroll down, you'll see it, someone else said. But what are you looking for?
Well, this has nothing to do with them. Christmas, November, December. The videos start right here.
Twin sister missing. Which one is it? What's it about? What's it called?
The boy Scott.
Wait a minute, is that a cameraman?
Hold on, right here?
Yeah.
Let's find out.
How the hell? Who's that guy? Hi, Michelle. And Jen. Who's that guy? Who are those people?
Yeah, where the hell were they at?
Who are they?
That's the uncle, I think. That's the
one. Well, that's not. That doesn't matter. Maybe. Doesn't match the description of the other uncle, but we haven't even seen the dad's brother or whatever. But, like, what? So, but who are those other people? That's not even what's, but what are we, where's what's her, where's Lisa? What video are you supposed to be looking
anything
for?
Anything ever happened to her, anybody has taken her, anything of that matter. I want anyone to know that God, I just want you to know that God sees everything. Jesus' name, thank you.
Was that a smile?
I ain't gonna lie to you. Something about that girl is evil.
Creepy, huh?
Creepy as hell. She might have killed her. Don't nobody say this shit. I guess I'm the only one gonna say that, huh? It was CFC Live. Listen, CFC Live. Boy, don't say that on her page. Please, come on, help me out.
Where are you?
I'm hungry as hell.
Live.
Come on, y'all.
I'm looking. Where does it say this? Can anybody drop a link? Anybody?
Okay, let me move this out the way again. These are the videos. These are recent videos starting right here. These videos.
Okay, Lise, how about this? Is this the right page or the wrong page? We'll start there.
I might be on the wrong page.
That's what I'm trying to figure out.
I got a half a sub in there.
Emojis? I don't know what that
4 o'clock
is.
In the morning.
Is this the right Facebook page or not?
If it isn't. Kales, be nice.
Okay, I need a yes or a no.
Got the box line over there. Peggy, are we on Peggy Fox page?
I just need a yes or a no. A yes or a no. Please.
No, hold on.
Stop it. Stop it.
Damn it, where it said.
Yes or no? Is it a yes? Is this, was that the right Facebook page or not? Was it a different page?
Hello, Vanna.
Peggy Fox News Live conference vid. Oh my God! Please tell me if that was the right Facebook page or not. Just a yes or a no.
Is it the right?
Is this the correct page? Is this the correct page? Yes or no? She said sorry. Jesus Christ. I'm gonna go in the other room and scream.
On that note, I gave you the moderator.
Said yes, you said yes.
We were moderator for 15, 20 minutes and we didn't get a link, not one link.
Okay,
I don't understand.
She said Peggy Fox News Live conference day.
Okay, let's see. Let's Google it. Maybe we'll get some better results.
Let's... No, she said that that's the right page. So let's look at the conference.
This is the conference video. Is this the video y'all talking about? Talking about this video?
Oh, yeah, that's it.
But this is about the person of interest. What am I going to get out of this?
Well, that's what we asked her in the first place. It's been so long that we forgot. But that's what you asked her because you said that she's claimed that he was arrested like way later. So let's listen to this. I don't want to listen to 18 minutes of it.
Yeah, I know. That's why I was like, oh my goodness. Let's do it.
Oh,
let's...
she's saying no. So what's yes? Oh, now you're messing with me. Now you're playing games with my
emotions. Yeah, you know, it's like salt in the wound. You know, they just you know, Hennessy just right in the damn cut. You know.
I mean, where's my wine? Okay, so that's the video. Can you tell us one last question? How far into this video?
And she has a delay. Okay, so how far in the video? Cause we're not going.
How far in the video is it that they say when he was incarcerated?
Okay, we'll get this shit. Hold on.
Just start playing it. I want, maybe they say it in the beginning.
I'm trying to wait.
Not sure, LOL.
Oh God, no. Lisa, are you trolling? I think you're trolling. He said near the end. Okay. We'll do the last 5 minutes.
I'm not able to give any information that's prohibited by law. The question is that there's reports out there, not by the police department, but by some of you who are reporting, then there's the...
You said middle, Q&A section. Okay.
Thank God. Who? Thank you.
That previous incident, the other, I'm not able to comment on what is or what is not out.
That he had a prior romantic
time. On that 13th of January, we go by the information, the best information that we have at the time. But circumstances tell us differently. We would have done what we did on subsequent days as well. But we are, we have certain standards. To make certain certain criteria. That's not to say that we were not concerned for showing. We interviewed an awful lot of people. We will continue. We will continue to interview people until we bring justice in this case. Yes, sir.
A 17-year-old is a person of interest. There's a story out there that the he had a prior romantic relationship with her and he didn't stay away with the plastic incident. Is that accurate?
Yeah. The question is, is there accurate information regarding the 17?
That's a contradiction right there. They said that was a stay away foul. First of all, what is a stay away? Is that not called a restraining order?
Yeah, but I don't know if it's something else. And
They said the assault was unreported. Do you remember that?
Exactly. Yeah, I do. Yeah,
it's unreported or it's not. Which one is it?
Right. Because how would you get a stay away or restraining order unless you reported an assault? There has to be a reason to get it. It has to be approved for a valid reason.
And if the assault happened, you had to call the police. If you did call the police, if you found a restraining order, you're basically saying, we don't want to have him arrested. We just want him to stay away.
Yeah.
Man, get the fuck out of here. Anyway.
...in prior legal proceedings that may or may not exist against that individual. I am prohibited by law to go into any aspects of trying to identify or the need to identify the identification of a juvenile. For that reason, I'm not able to comment on what is or what is not out there. I can tell you with a degree of comfort that we've got a person of interest who's a 17-year-old who remains in custody here in Fairfax County.
When was he arrested? What day was he arrested?
He's been charged with that previous incident, the but the question is, what was the 17-year-old being charged with? What is he currently charged with?
Why was he put back in jail?
He is being charged with let me clarify that here. The question is, so he is not charged with her gambling at this juncture. That is correct. He is not charged with her gambling.
I understand the 17-year-old was out.
The girl's saying that it was prior to this.
Stop with the propaganda. He's telling you no, but he's not telling you no. He's telling you prior he had a case and a stay away was granted.
Right.
But that still contradict. What they have is motherfuckers in this front row playing propaganda. They
he
keep
said
saying
he was arrested on a prior, but if he was arrested on a prior, but you were the one that told us that he was arrested after the fact.
No. What it is, well, I see what's going on here. They are saying, well, he was released. He was released and he was, no. That's what they doing. Because they're playing on the audience. It's called like this is the part of PSYOP too, where these two people sitting right here are telling you no without telling you no. But these people keep saying, pay attention to what they do. They keep saying listen to him. What day was he arrested? Asking what day was he arrested. They're trying to talk them.
Yep.
He was arrested.
They did not answer the question.
Yeah.
The question is, what was the 17-year-old being charged with? What's he currently charged with?
Why was he put back in jail?
See that? Why was he put back in jail? He has no right to tell you what he was thrown back in jail. Because he was thrown back in jail, from your understanding, he's in jail only for whatever he did. You don't know if it's more than once. They keep trying to ask them, they keep saying that to get them to admit to locking him up for the situation with Jolie. And that's a part of the game. That's propaganda. Either he's going to tell you or he ain't going to tell you.
He is being charged with, at this juncture, with a petition charging him with felony assault.
He's charged with felony assault, but if he's charged with felony assault, got nothing to do with the case.
Yeah, let me clarify that, Mary. The question is, so he is not charged with her death at this juncture.
That's what he didn't want to say, but he like, fuck it, I'll just tell y'all, no.
That's correct. He is not charged with her death.
I understand the 17-year-old was out of jail.
You see that? She keeps saying, I understand he was out of jail. That's not true. Because he's telling you he's in jail, which has nothing to do with her.
Exactly. So how is he a person of interest? Explain to me, somebody, how he's a person of interest when he's in custody. Because that's what started this whole thing while we're watching this in the first place.
Let me school y'all people. You remember when the Kanika Jenkins shit happened? What was the first thing they said? No, it wasn't Monifa first. It was the girl was there and she committed suicide because she knew what happened. That was a lie. That was a part of PSYOP too. Because remember, what happened to that girl that was going to kill herself with 7 knives in her hand? Like, who's going to commit suicide with 7 knives in her hand? But let's just throw that out the window. All right, so remember when Monifa got arrested? Remember that? He was questioned for
quote unquote, allegedly.
Allegedly. Yeah, everything legend on this show. Anyway, so listen, she wasn't arrested for that. Remember when Herman Tolliver, he was arrested. He's, remember that? Don't drop the soap, Tolliver. Remember that shit? Who has yet to still send me paperwork that she filed on Chosen, which that was fake. But she fake anyway, so. But remember they said that Herman Tolliver was arrested, but he was arrested for something totally different when he was arrested.
Oh, that's what it is. That's what it is. Totally saying that they said he was arrested on January 18th. That's what brought us here to this video. Like she just said it again. So she said he was arrested on January 18th.
Let's listen to that then. Watch.
He went back. What's the charge?
The charge is to get back. So this is a prior felony assault.
The question is, seeking clarity, was it a prior felony in charge? Yes. It was a prior incident that was discovered during the course of this investigation that had been unreported, as I stated.
I respectfully wanted to know, why was an Amber Alert issue?
Certainly. As you members of the media may or may not know, there are certain requirements and thresholds that must be met in order for a number of alerts to occur. One of those requirements is the fact that there is an abduction element. That there's an abduction, that we conduct an investigation, and then we can definitively say that during the course of our investigation, that an abduction occurred.
Right? What day was the arrest?
On the 18th. The question is, what day was he arrested?
Now, he was arrested on the 18th. Now, keep in mind, person of interest, it's not a charge. It's not an arrest. Can we go to bed now?
They say, wait, what did they say about the 18th?
He got arrested. But he can't be arrested if he's a person of interest. A person of interest is not an arrest. It's not a charge.
Exactly.
Period. Once again, can I go to bed now?
Okay. Nope.
We wasted all this extra time. We got nothing. We got nothing at all, but an answer I already knew the answer to. Like, he's going to be, even if it was the 18th. But I'm going to tell you the contradiction in this whole thing. I'll take you back to it. I'll take you back to it. Since y'all open up this can of worms, I'm gonna show you something.
Twin sister, she has a twin sister.
Twin sister. Their mother lives in Texas, but yeah. They live here with me, and their mother is always in communication with them.
Constant communication.
I know that she had an ex-boyfriend.
Ex-boyfriend. We're going with it now. Ex-boyfriend. All right. Now, we all know this was the 15th, right? 14th, 15th, is that right?
That was yes. So this day where they're actually doing this, that was supposed to be Monday, the 14th, right?
Yeah, it was before the 18th. We ain't got to figure out what day it was. We know it was before the 18th, wasn't it? Let's go. Hey. Let's go.
Was going through some issues with, but she ended up, that issue kind of...
Are you hoping...
You see what I was telling you about how he looked around? You see that?
Yeah, he's been talked to, right?
He fucked up. You see that? He like, shit. And then he was like, well, she was like, well, he's been talked to, right? This to him.
Yeah, he's been talked to by the police, by myself. He doesn't fit the description of the guy who uses the cell phone.
Boom. Mm-hmm.
He's not dark-skinned, he's light-skinned.
Not dark-skinned, he's light-skinned. It's sort of like the situation with Tupac thing, and I'd like to go way back to that. The Tupac story is that the guy that was the shooter was light-skinned. Gaddafi was the one that said he was light-skinned.
Look at that look on his face.
And he said, quote, not light, but light, not light like me, but light. And everybody know Gaddafi from the Outlaws was damn near mixed. You know, that's how light he was. He looked like Busy Bone. You know what I'm saying? So, Reggie Wright is light-skinned. He's damn near red, you know, real light-skinned. So, I always tell people, how are you going to say Orlando is the shooter when he's not light-skinned? He couldn't have been the one shooting because Gaddafi said he was light-skinned, right? Just like this man just said, the guy described is dark-skinned with twist. He's not dark-skinned, he's light-skinned. So the boyfriend is light-skinned, so he's obviously not the one they're looking for. But there's always a but. Listen to him.
We're hoping that the police doesn't rule him out.
Yeah, hoping the police don't rule him out.
Why would that make
Who knows? Mm-hmm. There's nothing home-wise that would cause her to run away.
Right.
So, Saturday night, we were concerned, but we were still like, okay, if she did, she should come back today.
Right.
She's never been away from home more than a day or so.
Now,
from spending the night on the
beach. When did y'all call police?
We called police on Saturday evening around 5.
Mm-hmm.
So
the you just figured she was going to come out because she said she was going to a friend's house. This is why they didn't call immediately, right?
That too, but also the her sister knew the truth.
That she was.
Listen, listen to what he's about to say.
She wasn't at the friend's house.
She wasn't at the friend's house. She was hiding in secret.
But he's about to say a couple times how the sister lied.
Her sister.
That's what was really alarming. That was what.
Because if her sister wouldn't have said anything, we would have thought, okay.
Communicate with her after Friday, right?
Her sister would try to call her, but her phone wasn't.
So were waiting till Saturday, maybe till Friday. Was she?
She was waiting.
She was waiting.
All right, so again, parents, we were in the dark. So her sister said after she couldn't call her.
Oh, I said you got to study shit. He said parents are in. We are in the dark. And remember, their story is he just flew in and the mom just flew in. So I find it insulting to the intelligent mind that you would say he's the sole fucking suspect. Keep in mind, he said it himself. We are in the dark. The sister know everything and she hid it.
Yeah, that's what he's saying basically.
Yeah, so come on, y'all got to think a lot better than that. I don't mean no disrespect to nobody who's out there saying that shit. Y'all got to start thinking a lot better than that.
Someone said that's who killed Kanika.
The next morning.
Okay, I forwarded you just one last thing before we go, Huggy. I forwarded you an email that was just sent to me, and it's supposed to be the video that they're talking about.
Oh my God, no! I'm not gonna ask who sent that. Was it somebody reliable?
Yes.
Oh, it is. Okay, they are reliable. Okay, yeah, I trust it. I trust you. Let's get it.
It's there. Yes, the sweetie.
Oh no! We just watched this video. Oh!
Did he play it? I can't.
Hold on. Oh my goodness! Wait a minute. That's the chick that was in the fucking kitchen, wasn't it? That we just found out was somebody else there? That's the camera they used too.
I don't know because we can't see.
Hold on. Oh man. Hold on.
I'm gonna watch it myself.
No. now we got what we wanted. Whatever video we watched, it wasn't showing. It was, yeah, I know, right? It wasn't even showing the light. Okay, hold on. No, stop it. I was showing it.
Oh, my God.
You spoiling it. Hold on. Let me show it to the people.
Oh, my God.
I know, right?
Oh, my God. Thank you, Miss Sweet B, for sending that to me.
Because whoever put the video up in another way, they hid it.
Hi, everybody.
Hold on. Let me blow it up. All right, are we here? No, we're not here yet. Okay, we here now. Oh. All right, make sure we there.
Yeah, but make it big.
Okay, make it big. Let's see. I think it can't get no bigger than that, right?
Oh, right. Yeah, we're winding.
Yeah, we're at the beginning.
Hi, everybody. I just want to give you an update. Joni Deborah Renee Musa has not been found yet. She went missing Friday.
You see the shirt? Memphis Tigers.
Who the hell is recording them?
I'll tell you, look at that shirt, though. Look at that shirt, too, though. It say Memphis Tigers.
Oh, stop it.
Yeah, I know. That's Memphis Tigers on the shirt.
Oh, come on.
And we still haven't found her, and today is the 16th, Monday the 16th.
Okay.
We're still looking for her.
Does everyone else see that?
Everyone.
So what?
Does everyone else see Jolie recorded them?
I can't see who. It looked like Jolie. That looks like Jolie. Let's start at the top. Is that Jolie, y'all? Hold on. Is that her? That's shit.
Do you guys see that?
Hold on, let me get my spray drop on. Hold on, y'all.
That looks like her. I don't know who else it could have been because we haven't seen any other family members that look like that. And this is a Facebook video. This isn't like the news video or nothing like that. So it's not
Well, you know, she ain't got no braids.
And you believe what they say? We don't know what she has right there because it looks like she has a hoodie on.
Well,
maybe she has a hoodie on.
I'll get my straight drop on.
The girl that left the house.
What y'all think? Is that possibly her? We need the person holding the phone. We can't say it looked like her. We can't even see the fucking eyes. We just see the structure of the face.
Well, it's all blurry, like on your
thing. It's blurry.
Was not that blurry.
I mean, on my computer, it's in HD. We see their faces. We can't see the face in the mirror.
I just want to give you an update. Jolie, Deborah Renee Musa, has not been found yet. She went missing Friday, the 12th, and we still haven't found her. Monday the 16th. We're still looking for her. I just want to send a plea out to everyone. To Jolie.
Cause you know when you
zoom if you in, have left the home,
because you know when you zoom in, you're gonna lose the resolution. That's the best image you can get of seeing if that's her or not. But she don't have.
I just zoomed in. I'm gonna send you the picture right now. Maybe.
I'm sorry. Which I highly doubt. But
Took some. Yeah, y'all see it. I'll be on some shit, bro. You see that download? Ooh, quick. Got it.
And then you can keep it. And then it will be downloaded forever, even if they deleted it.
Yeah, they have to come kill me to get it. All right, go down around. You got to come take it from me. You got to come hack my shit. Shout out to the hackers. I know y'all in the bushes.
How did you know, Miss Crenshaw, that pig in the kitchen with what?
It appears it was the 10 on the 15th is jumping.
Wait a minute, what?
He's saying the girl is jumping. I know what she's talking about too. The picture where they were smiling. She said that's Jolie. I'm still trying to figure out how to tell them apart. I can't. I haven't tried. Because
there's two pictures with the family.
I'm gonna go to that picture too because I know she's
gonna be Jolie because the dad said that for Christmas she got blonde braids and that she still had blonde braids. So there's no blonde braids in the girl in that picture. So how could it be? How could that be Jolie? Where's the blonde braids at?
I know what picture she's talking about.
Well, where's the blonde braids at? But the parents said that she had blonde braids. She got blonde braids for Christmas.
This is the picture right here.
Those aren't blonde braids. That's not her.
She don't have blonde braids, that's another contradiction. So even if we're wrong, they're wrong. That's how it is. It's like.
So which one has a space in her teeth?
You can take the blonde braids.
one that passed away.
So explain this. Oh, that's the other dude, Cable. Explain this same picture, right? Hold on. Explain this picture. Bam! Same outfit, same face. Is that her?
So that girl doesn't have a gap in her teeth.
There you go. See? Gotcha. Let me see the zoom in. Let's see the zoom in, y'all.
I'm just saying, if they're lying about the braids, they said that she still had them because that's what it was taken. And why would they post a picture with just Jolie and not the other twin?
This lady looks older. Whoever this is holding this camera.
You could send the pics.
She looks a lot older.
Which one?
This girl, she zoomed in on, she looks a lot older.
I know.
But maybe, just maybe, they kind of like fuzzed and edited her face. But it looked like whoever this is got braids. They just all tangled up. So we don't dismiss that. We dismiss that being Joey. Yeah, that theory only lasts, 2 minutes? 2 or 3 minutes?
But I thought that, which one of the two girls has a gap between her teeth? Which one?
You want me to zoom? We can zoom this one in. This is bigger pixels. Let's get my straight drop on.
Which one of them has a gap between her teeth?
Gap in the teeth? So my bitch. Got to fit. What's it? That was some gap. Gay ass shit the nigga said when you think about that song. I don't see no gap at all. I'll tell you what, let's make a gap. We're gonna do some editing, okay? So make a gap. Now she got a gap.
Stop it.
Now that's Jolie.
Stop it.
Let's zoom out. It's Jolie, and I'm fucking with y'all. But look. Look, I'm fucking with y'all. All right, so look.
The gap is...
I don't see no gap. Hashtag.
I don't see no gap. So when you go to the girl in the interview had a gap between her teeth? I'm getting confused.
I don't see no gap.
Just shut up out here.
What you doing, boy? No, I don't want to play. You see me clapping, you like, oh, shit, playtime. No, nigga, it's almost 3 in the morning.
The girl in the interview, I'm watching it right now. She has no gap in her teeth. Gap in her teeth.
Yeah. Gap teeth are sexier, by the way.
But she doesn't have one.
I don't see no gap.
So that means that's John A. Because I think our dad seen that one of them did have a gap, but it can't be... Jolie, has to be Johnny that has a guy, right?
Let me shout another wonderful YouTube out. My guy, Dazi Kadazi. Subscribe to her.
Oh yeah, I did.
She the one put me on a game about transferring the memory into a computer chip. Subscribe to her. Good people. Unlike Chosen, I'm not gonna tell you to sub to me. And Mune Ramos, what's up with you? We got Miss J all day to be able to subscribe to her, because that's where that video that we were playing came.
Scott, I don't want to go sleep.
What's up, T?
I don't want to. And it's only 12:30.
Because we need too many ears. Oh man! Kim said, "Sorry, we chipping in. Y'all finna smoke out? Look at y'all. We got Leah here from Germany.
Honey, I don't want it.
We got Mr. Bonet here that can't give us links to the proper video. But what's up with you? We got Lee. Oh, I always say Lee. Like Draymond, he's still here." How many people watch it? You know, unless you know, I don't give a fuck how many people watch it. Just you know, listen. I'd be like, just hey, look, if it's just one or two, so it could just. So, yeah. Listen, me and Christian, I was sitting up running out of mouth for no reason.
Huh?
When the first one quit, we was like, I looked at the chat, I said, the chat ain't moving.
Yeah.
And I saw somebody said, I think he went to go eat that sandwich. I was like, I ain't ate that sandwich yet. I'm sitting up thinking the chat room is stopped. I didn't even know this shit was over with.
I know, and I'm like, and then somebody said, is he finished or is he done? And I'm like, what? And you said, I'm trying to hurry. There's a lot of information.
Yeah.
And we were alive.
Hey, mark my word. If there's a funeral here, I don't give a fuck if I'm working. I will call off. I'm going to that funeral. It'll be in the daytime. Hopefully, I don't work in the daytime. No way. I'm going. Cherry Glamour is still in here. We got Cherry Girl in here. We got both chairs in the building. That's needed. Is up in here.
Yeah.
Angel is in the building. Got Michelle in here. We got Nicola. I had ate my sandwich on the slick. Miss Godiva. Yeah, I ate it on the slick side. Zanae has a gap on. I tell y'all one thing.
Man, which one has it?
These kids are bleaching their skin. I tell you that goddamn much. They bleaching the hell out their skin. Y'all missed the part one where they were darker. They were damn near my color. Gray Hughes would have debunked the gap. Hey, Gray Hughes here. Talk about the grab too. Joey's not. Well, people say it's Joey. It's not Joey's. It's Sinead. Joey's dead, remember? No, he's sarcastic as hell. That's what I like about his ass. I'm going to zoom in here and show you that there's no gap. Oh, yeah, but let's get this out the way. This is not Joey, ladies and gentlemen. If you
yeah, I don't think so.
Happen, if you just so happen to zoom in, you can noticeably see through the blurry image, this is an older woman, okay? This is not 16 years old, ladies and gentlemen. And we're going to zoom out here. You know, the grieving mother. We're going to talk about her later. Anyway.
I'm looking on her Facebook page. Neither one of them really have a gap.
I know Gray Hughes is listening to this shit like this shit funny. Because he subbed to me. I can't believe he did, but he does. He subbed to my channel. That's real shit.
Huggy, I'm going to send you a picture right now.
No more pictures.
Well, no, because we're going to deal with this. Now I need to know about this gap.
Yo, side note, has anybody ever listened to Dre Day and be like, that's a gay ass song?
I don't think I've ever thought that deep about it.
Yeah, like the last verse. Now understand this, my nigga Dre can't be fucked with. Luke's bending over, so Luke's getting fucked. I don't see a gap.
Oh,
see
yeah.
Baby teeth.
I know that there isn't a gap.
Oh,
I'm trying to
tell you. Jay
all day says that there's a gap.
Because I used to hang with Easy.
And I'm maybe they had braces at one point, but those teeth are just being divorced, have been divorced and separated. Those to her teeth, the picture I just sent Huggy is from 2014. And there wasn't a gap.
Yeah, they were like babies.
That girl looks like Jeanne and with the family.
What did they say? I'll show y'all the lyrics. This is a very disturbing song. He said,
what's making you think of this song?
It ain't another hoe that I got to fuck with. Got teeth in your mouth, so my dick's got to fit. And then Snoop said, with my nuts on your tonsils while you're on stage rapping at your concert. And Dre said, and I'ma snatch your ass from the backside. This is sounding like a threesome, a raping threesome. That's what it sounds like. These four lines right here are very disturbing. I'm just saying. Like, I don't know. Maybe I think too deep into shit. Like what Pac said, we can do this like gangsters and slug it out. We can do this like punks, punk it out.
I don't have an email. Let me see. Did she email you, Hucky?
If he did, I don't know. I have to go look. I don't know. I got a picture from Don Diva. I see. See, I don't know who's who. Don Diva, who's Zane and who's the girl? I have to learn who's who.
Put the picture up.
It's like looking at Kane and Ava. I can't never tell them niggas apart. And I've been watching them for 20 years. I be looking at Kane and Ava. Like, who the fuck is Kane? The fuck niggas look alike. You know who does look like them? That's Shelby. It's a girl I know named Shelby. She kind of looks like them. That's what used to throw me out. There's a girl named Shelby that kind of looked like her and their damn mom. I need to ask her, do you fucking know these people? But she kind of favors them a little bit. With those damn African like type features in the
sky with who?
Structure of the face. Maybe I'm bugging though. The fuck is that nigga going through? What the hell? Shade tree? What the hell?
What the hell?
That ain't gonna help nothing. That's your fault. Tell me what happened.
The fuck?
I went to this girl's shop. It wasn't even a shop, it was a shed house. Saloon.
Say true salon. Hell nah.
Y'all out there was telling me that I need to do something to my hair, so I was like, I'm gonna get this money and I'm gonna do something with my hair. And you done for the money too. You pay to get your hair done, you paying for it. And I let this girl get in my head, y'all. And she didn't know what she was doing.
Oh my God.
Got you looking like a skin coon. Show him. Show him your head. Hold your head down. Move your head.
Oh, look no.
Look like you got the mangers by the head.
Oh, man.
Tell him who set you up to do it.
That nigga held it like Kanika in the freak.
You need to stop.
You know how to do hair real good. And the girl inboxed me her name. Tell him the girl name. You don't tell him I tell her Samantha. And she told myself she know how to do her then when I show her this picture. And what she say? Tell her what she say. You can stop crying because they ain't going to help your hair grow back. She going to tell myself she know she ain't seen she did though by the hair, but she say she heard she can do hair real good. Got you looking like you premature by the head, girl. I'm glad you crack a joke. Y'all don't be like this German Shepherd. Go get the German Shepherd. Houston, Texas. Call me. 357790.
Oh, let me get up out of here. I'm mad as hell. She, I need to holler at her, man. She, where Tonio? Tony, I ain't say Tonio in a while. I ain't think Tonio been over here. And what, 2 or 3 months? I need to see if he all right. Let's talk about, let me see what Tony was at. Oh, man. So we back. Man. I mean, damn, did I say, I ain't mean to hurt nobody's feelings. I know we probably got some J4Ks in here somewhere. He might be in the bushes. But that did look like Kanika in the freezer here. I'm just saying, it does.
Stop it.
I don't think Kanika's dead. I'd rather believe she's alive, you know? I'm just saying.
Right. Yeah.
This is play my
demo. Oh, Kiara's here?
You got a demo?
Where's Kiara?
Hey, Kiara in the building. It's so cold in the deep. It's real cold. It says a 16-year-old girl missing up there now.
What?
Yeah.
It's like that, y'all. It's like that,
not an email. Oh, okay, okay.
What, the email? I didn't get, I don't know if you sent an email to you. I didn't get an email.
No, she's talking about me. Oh, well, maybe she sent it to you too. But yeah, I did got an email. I haven't read it. It's open, but I haven't looked at it.
Well, look at it.
She got said shut up right now. Oh, man. TT, what you doing, Needy? TT, what you doing, Needy? TT, what you doing, Needy? Oh, wait a second. Shut up. Hey, play to the face. Play to the face, bro, when you see this
That's
shit.
My guy. As you
always hey, I told man, look. We were talking about age of consent, right? Because that's how I met Planet of the Fakes about a year ago, the age of consent video. I don't have Miss Crenshaw email, so I said, Crenshaw, you want me to put it out? You want to put your email out there?
I'll put it out again.
Crenshaw1981@gmail.com.
Did you, what's
you,
in the
you bitch ass niggas get blocked. You know, you're gonna come correctly. Not correctly. If you're gonna come correct, you know, come correct. You know.
Oh yeah, remember that one time I ever put my, I said my email like in your chat, like when I first came to one of the lives and then some guy.
Yeah, dude. Email me. He said, what did he say? He said,
he want to spend some money. He took a picture of himself holding up money. He was like, you want to spend some of this money, girl?
Western Union. MoneyGram. A lot cheaper. It's a lot faster. You can Walmart to Walmart. Just make that shit happen, you know?
Sky, but I love you. Give you no.
I tell you what, we got to come up with it. Like, we got to come up with a name. Like, we do shit like this more often. What can we name this? Because you with Crenshaw, Tarantino, Huggy Venturi. we gonna roll with that.
We're really just.
Huggy Venturi, you can't.
Who needs to stand in the corner? Me or Huggy?
I need y'all come up with a name. Come up with a name where me and her could do like live feeds. Like, this guy said, "Fuckery."
What did we do?
I said, "Fuckery."
Oh, I'm having a great time. I don't know.
Beauty and Chocolate Thunder. Oh my god. Oh yeah, by the way, I do have a new company called Visions Productions. You know what I'm saying? I took Chosen Voices, now my company. We doing big things over here.
The fuckery hour? No. Because it's
going to
be more like 2 or 3 hours, so that wouldn't even feel
yeah, bad. I think we've been about 4 or 5 hours so far. Colombo Asian number 9. Number 9. Yo. The Diamond Duo. That's plain. But I like that, the Diamond Duo. You know, call y'all Chicken and Waffle. Chicken and Waffle. God damn right here. That's the shit. Chicken and Waffle. That's it. That's why Kiara's the shit. I know you know, Kiara. Only Kiara will come up with something jiggies like that. Chicken and waffle. what Charlamagne you saying? Waffle color? You be waffle colored.
Found it, y'all matching
pictures. He said waffle color Negro. He called
Well, where did you send it to you, Miss J? I've yet to get an email. Huggy's not opening his email because he's afraid someone's gonna see something they don't like.
I can shut it down. I can shut it down. I'm just tired. you know, I'm on my fan shit, but I can't go to sleep. I've done it before, and I refuse to do it again. You remember that, right? I know. Gap bed. She said gap bed. Okay, it's a gap, but it's not a real noticeable gap. Not really.
Yeah, not really.
I see it, though.
Well, I don't see the picture you're looking at, but I was just looking at her Facebook pictures and, like, I sent it to your 1981
email. See, now she got me singing the gap band. Thank you, Ms. J.
The gap band, stop it.
Yeah, but she said she wrote that. She said gap band. I said, damn, now I'm saying outstanding and shit. See? Outstanding. I'm gonna blow him up. Blow him up, son.
She said that she sent a new one to you, I guess.
Yeah, so, I got two emails, so she sent me another email.
Ebony and Ivory.
I like Chicken and Wild. Chicken and Wild was the shit. That's just that's just a funny title. This Chicken and Wild. Or we could just call the show Chicken and Wobbles. You could be Christian.
When they said chasing gaps.
Gap gate. Let's see. All right, so let's blow this thing up. Let's close these out first. I got so much stuff open. I gotta make sure I don't get caught saying the wrong thing about somebody. Shit is complicated. Damn, Mom, I ain't gonna lie. Mama got a little chunky, man.
Show your email.
Yeah, she got kind of a little chunky. She got that damn military money with that dude and shit. She got big. All right, here we go. Okay. Now I understand. Now I understand who's who. So now I can get the, so.
Well, wait. Do you?
Yeah, I see the thinner face. She got the rounder face.
But how old is this picture? Because that's girl, because the John A. Yeah. That's the aunt, right?
No, that's the mom. Let me see.
But look at whose page it was on.
If y'all call this a gap.
I don't call that a gap.
I mean, it's
they both have it. Zoom in on the other one. They both have it. It's like, a tiny little space. See?
She has more of a gap than she do. If this is what I'm looking at, she looks more. It looks okay. Yeah, it is bad.
That's what I'm saying.
It's not noticeable though. It's like those still baby teeth. I mean, we really having a gap gate right now.
I.
This is not a gap. I mean, y'all won't see a gap. She has a real gap too. This is a real gap too. Let me show y'all.
Stop it. Look at that one.
Strahan. There go Mike Strahan. Let me show y'all. It's Mike Strahan. And this is a real gap too, ladies and gentlemen. Please. That's Michael Strahan, Hall of Fame. That's a real gap too. That's a real gap too right there.
Yes.
Yeah. See, this is a gap too. Gap too. See how you can noticeably see the tongue? Now that's a slight gap, but it's not as bad as the other one. He has a gap too. Willie Harrelson. I know Michael Strahan again. This nigga.
Oh, stop it. Beetlejuice.
Not even got a gap. I didn't know that. literally got a damn gap between the two.
A little bit.
Whoa. God damn. Yo, my nigga got the dog team, yo. Oh my god. You listen, bro. When your team look like that, nigga, you couldn't brush these few. Nigga, I was 2 or 3 or 5. How many?
Oh, hey, I just got a text.
Help me
clear this up. My mom just texted me too. She's asking me the same question, so I just want to be clear. Was he previously incarcerated at the time of her disappearance? Which one is it?
At the time of disappearance, according to them, they didn't mention it. According to this press conference, he was arrested on the 18th.
It's God, don't blame me for this gap dilemma. This is not my fault.
According to what they said in the press conference, they said on the 18th he was arrested.
He was arrested on the 18th?
Right. But the people in the interview, the family, they said that prior there was an issue with them, but he didn't say what. The ex-boyfriend had an issue with them. They didn't say what exactly it was.
So, but did they say at any time during the interview, the family interview, that didn't they say he was incarcerated?
No, they didn't say he was incarcerated. They never mentioned it. They mentioned something about an altercation. And then even in the news, when they did mention him being a person of interest, the news themselves says that he had a prior incident. And they also said that it was an incident that involved Jolie where it wasn't reported. That's exactly what they said. I have to find it, but that's exactly what they said. So this is Jolie. So where was Zanae at?
Exactly. If that's Jolie, I don't think it looks like Jolie. I think it looks like Janae, the girl that was in the kitchen talking to us. Light,
man. You can Photoshop there as to who you want to be, yeah.
Because one thing is none of her pictures does she really have that like super straight sleek like weave like the sister does,
and that's the girl from Florida, that's the Tanisha girl.
But how is she, who is she to them?
She's a sister.
Doesn't look anything like her. The mom looks young there.
Yeah, she looks smaller. She ain't even that size no more.
Yeah, no.
Is that a tiger? Tiger! Okay, let me stop. Alright, I'm about to pass out. I'm being up like fed on y'all ass in a minute.
I know.
Yeah, I get it. I might get turned into 100 chops.
Sky wants us to go to bed anyway. She had enough of our shit.
100 chops. Cold. I really enjoyed this. Y'all have, well, technically, y'all have enjoyed the Chicken and Waffle Hour by Crenshaw Tarantino and Uggy Venture.
Go to bed, now.
Oh, I got my eyes. Ooh, my eyes have seen the glory. I just want to thank y'all for tuning in. Anything else you want to say, Crenshaw?
No, I just want to say it was fun. It was nice. I loved the that you rolled up on the funeral home, so that was interesting. And we'll just be keeping everybody updated. I'm gonna work tomorrow on. I was gonna put up a video, like I was saying, just about some of the other like contradictions, and then something else I found out about Alexandria. So we'll be letting you guys know as far as like the funeral, and I want to see what the autopsy is about and all that. Right. I ain't had enough, Sky.
Oh yeah, we pulling up. Funeral here, we pulling up. all day. Yeah. And I ain't coming by myself.
You're going to be recording?
I have a crew because I don't trust these folk, man. Don't tell them what the fuck they might do to me. They were like, that's that nigga from YouTube. I was like, run up. I'm going with a few people. You know what I'm saying? I ain't got to worry about it. We going out. They'll be like,
that's needed. Thank you. Yeah, I did one last night, and then I'll put one up tomorrow on some dates.
Oh, Jesus. Listen, I got.
I don't see no gap.
I gotta get. I gotta. I have a situation where my job, truthfully speaking, I ignored her phone call tonight. Because I know what she tried to do. She tried to get me come to work. So I was like, it's just so last minute. I just literally was about to broadcast, right? And I was like, what the fuck? Call me at 11 o'clock. So I was like, nah, I ain't going tonight. So then I said, you know what? They ain't giving me no full-time work. So the dude that owned the company is not holding his bargain. Like, bro, you said I'm supposed to fall back on you, bro. What's going on, man? So now I'm going to have to go get me another job. I ain't worried about looking. I'm going to go get me a job in the morning.
Right.
But the security company's all over this bitch. And if I got experience, man, I'm in the door. I ain't worried about that. You know what I'm saying? My resume is impressive too, Miss Sarita Hill.
Stop.
I got an impressive resume too. I do security too. Yeah. Yeah, I got, how much experience I got? 2005, 2004, 2005. I got 14 years experience too, Sarita Hill. Yeah. Yeah. Anyway, but I'm from Memphis though. Anything y'all want to say? Anybody want, listen, check, oh, fuck it. 10 minutes, anybody want to get on the panel and shout themselves out? About 5 or 10 minutes. Anybody? I want to join the panel.
Negative.
Everybody want to join the panel? Y'all
go get to up. Fucking bed.
Listen, Kales, get on because I know you drunk. You want to get on here? I know you on that box line.
He said negative.
Get over here. Just get over here and just say whatever you want to say. Just talk about your nigga that came to you. You'll talk about your baby mama. She ain't shit. Just get on up here and say that shit. Come on. Air an opportunity. As long as it ain't about no.
I think Jay just said. Jay wants to come up.
Okay. I'm gonna send you the link, Jay. Planet of the Fake. Oh shit. What's up? Planet of the Fake just came out the bushes. Planet of the Fake just came out the bushes on these niggas. He wanna get on the panel around this motherfucker. I've been sitting what's up, Planet of the Fake? I've been sitting I know your email though. I'm in the wrong email. I can't keep up. I got 10 emails. It's hard to keep up, man. I'm trying. Oh, yeah. I saw that in the video. She had the cowardly lion. I'm going to show that, though. I got to show that before I go. The cowardly lion. Yo. All right. Let me send Ms. J to the link. Ms. J, you on?
Wait a minute, what the heck? My mom says it sounds like when they were looking through surveillance.
What's up, Ms. J?
My ass and my fingers all get swollen and shit. I got smoke coming off my fingers. No, okay. This is what I was trying to tell y'all. Okay. If I can show y'all real quick on the screen, on the screen share.
Okay, hold on. One second. What the fuck?
There's a picture from Facebook. It is dated from the 21st. And it's the one in the kitchen that I was just showing y'all. when the doctors pulled up with the two dark-skinned aunts.
Yes.
She has on the flannel, the red and black flannel shirt, the black coat. That's the same person that's on the flyer that says Find Jolie. Jolie has a skinnier, not skinnier, but thinner face and higher eyebrows. Janae has thicker eyebrows, and like because when she was in the video and they were doing the interview, she was like, she's not in control. Like, I was looking at that.
In this picture, in this side by side, which one is Jolie, which one is Janae?
I can tell which one is which. Like, the one right? Janae has the meaner looking face. She's always has the more serious looking face. And
oh, the one on the left.
I fucked up, but I thought it was the left one. I thought I had it right.
And then the tattoo on Jolie keeps switching. So I think they're using both of them.
Yeah, that I was just going to say that doesn't make any sense because that picture that they use also in like the flyer and every look at the picture that's on the flyer that you just pointed out has her tattoo on the other arm. So if you're saying that's Johnny, then this is also Johnny.
Yeah, but Johnny is the one here on the right side, on the side of the lion. I'm a mean old lion.
Johnny is on the which side?
Johnny is on the left side.
But that's just
a throw off.
But that's the girl in the flyer, though.
No, no, the one in the flyer is the one on the right. They just want
the tattoo.
I know the tattoo. The girl in my, like, I did it in my, pointed it all out in my video. Me and Logic did it. And we looked at it for like 2 days, this video and like all the pictures. That's why I was saying I think they're using both of them. Because the girl in the flyer and the girl on another flyer, the girl in the white tank top that's on that flyer. And in another flyer that's supposed to be Jolie, the tattoos are on different arms. One is on the right, one is on the left. See, they both have the same infinity tattoo with both names on it. But if you look at all, I have all the flyers right here. I have them pulled up. And the same girl likely, it's on, what's her name? Jolie's.
You open it. It's all on you.
I got these daggone things up here. I think they just playing. I knew the mother was lying. But like, if you look at that, I have the like still images of the okay, look.
Alright.
Hold on, here's one. Oh,
Planet of the Fakes
in the building. What's up, bro?
What's up, my guy?
Okay. Man, Anika Ville.
You know he gonna say they ain't from here because you know a lot of West Indians and Jamaicans are doing it. Like you, there's documentaries on YouTube. They bleach their skin because it makes them look. It's like a fad to show that you know what I'm saying. You got money and stuff like that. So they do bleach. But that
Hey, what's going on? Y'all can hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Anika Ville, what's up?
The Alexandria, Virginia area is very heavy in Nigerians or Africans from Niger and stuff like that. They are business owners. They got money. I used to live in Virginia for over a decade. So, but they got some money. And my sister, they're still heavy out there. My sister was, you know, she lives in the VA area, and Logic was stationed. They got friends out there too. So it's like a lot of us, you know, that know that area, they're heavy with because they don't look like they're American.
No,
I know they're pronouncing the name Jolie like as if they spoke Creole or something like that. Then the mother, quote unquote, changed it to Jolie, and then she's going back and forth with the Jo and the Jolie. You see what I'm saying? If you are a specific nationality, you're not gonna keep switching it up, you know, just for cameras and things like that. That's just, you know, my point of view on it, but. This girl here, you can see her tattoo is right there. I don't know if y'all was able to. Look who is sharing this flyer.
Yeah, okay.
What?
I got it on you. Look.
You got it, Teresa Martin?
Yeah, I got it on you. It's all on you.
Oh, no. Can you see it?
No, we can't. We see. It's like a long shot. It's real long. All we see is a folder, a picture on the right. It's not showing your whole screen.
I got you. I see it. Okay, hold on, my bad. Let me just do the whole type screen. All right, there we go. Yeah, y'all can see now?
Yeah, I'll see.
Okay. Now, this is this picture here where Jolie has the tattoo. Is showing that this is on her right arm here, her right, but here it's on her left. If I go to edit real quick, just lighten up the picture. I had to do up, but just look, you see who's sharing the
Teresa Meyer.
Mm-hmm. And she was in the comic, but she had took the daggone comment out because we were just on beds on live one day and we were just looking at the pictures. And somebody kept telling me to look close, and I'm like, look at what? But I didn't realize that she was, it's hard to see, but I got it on my video, but her tattoo is right here.
Right.
Her tattoo, so that would mean it's on her left here and on her right here. I said, I think they're using both of them, but,
What if that's
then, yep, this picture here.
What if that's reverse image?
That's what be a reverse image. How could it be a reverse image when you're only showing one side, though?
Right, and I flipped the camera. I took like a picture of myself. Logic did it on a private live just to do a camera because the reporter, you know, just for the interview part, the reporter was using her cell phone. They didn't use the equipment they had because I had still shots of them in the background over by the kitchen.
Right.
And there's another picture I have with the mom. Her hair is different. So I think they're doing like what we've seen in the Kanika situation where they had been using footage that was previously recorded, but, you know, pulled off as a live somehow.
Right.
I didn't figure that one out yet. But if you see, this is supposed to be Find Jolie. This is right now. I just pulled this on Facebook. And it's dated for the 15th of January. So 15th January, she's supposed to be missing. This is in the kitchen. You see that stove back there? With some type of appliance.
Yeah. Damn.
See that? That's why I was typing in the daggone thing. I'm like, oh, my fingers.
Yeah, they plant.
Okay. Yeah, now they're all sharing in Ashanti. Really?
Well, that's what I'm saying. But that's what I was saying. If it's, well, so wait a minute. So they're using a picture of her. That was uploaded. I mean, I guess you could go with the narrative. I suppose that it wasn't taken that day, that they just uploaded it on that day. But
true. But why we use the same picture? You see what I'm saying? The same clothing and everything like that. Fly. That's the point that got me.
Yeah, they could have just switched it up if they were smart. But
why use the picture with their tongue out?
People are not smart enough to realize it, so they'll do it. Like, fuck it.
It's not even this is this one. This
like is I'm just seeing that for the first time, and I'm looking like that's not supposed to be her, but because this
exactly.
is somebody else, but it's not. It's the same fucking girl.
And this one could be Janae because Janae has the rounder.
Yeah, she.
I'm gonna show y'all. Now, but did y'all notice Dad's his wound kept flipping on each side of his face, right?
Right. So you know these 16. Now you know 16-year-olds could play the games like they do. If they money,
of course, he was doing
that. Just like this criminal like, shit is fake too. All this shit is fake.
What do you think about
it? Yeah, and you know, I was on her profile, so I do know what y'all are saying with the not being from Ohio, because look, on each of their profiles, they say they're from, I mean, Colorado. They say they're from Colorado Springs. So yeah. I ain't children out there, and you're not there. So I get that. Why I just didn't take her freaking profile, but I took Janae.
Yeah.
You see her face is a little bit rounded, but she's in a darker image. But they could be flip-flopping, taking pictures for each other.
Yo,
but as they get older, you know. Oops, huh?
Yeah, Planet of the Face.
Okay. Planet of the Face, what do you think?
Okay. What did you say?
What do you think?
Not from here. Okay, here we go.
What do you think about all this?
Well, first of all, did you see the picture I put on the part one where I found
no, the younger? Delay
what?
Delay? You're getting a delay.
Yeah, I can't even, like, I just hear Huggy and Jay.
Yeah, she's the only one talking.
I just spoke up and I asked you what you think of everything. Like, what do you think of all of this?
Here it is.
All right.
Yeah, we hear you. Go ahead.
I still hear Jay. I was just trying to give her a second.
Oh, no, she quiet. We waiting on you.
Oh, all right. It's fake. It was fake from day one. Who's that reporter?
Right.
I'm like Bruce Jenner.
That's Caitlin. Yeah. That's Caitlin right there.
She been covering a lot of psyops. That's her MO. We get the psyop, you hold it down. She walk in that bitch and she know everything. She coaching them on what to say. Like, come on, man. And that motherfucking lady is not from here, but they's trying to set up a funeral here. Shit is just weird. And I went to the funeral home today and they told me nothing concrete yet. Like, dude, your website letting them know how concrete it is. But I'll hold it to him. I'm gonna hit him up later on today. He got 12 fucking hours to get his mind right. I don't know. Depends on how I feel. I might just call or I might pull up. I want to talk. It's like that, y'all. Yeah, it's like fake. Yeah? Playing a fake?
Say something, because we all...
Yeah, I'm still here. I was just trying to catch up with the delays.
Yeah, I think you got a delay.
I don't even know how to quiet y'all. I was trying to quiet y'all.
Oh, no, you go ahead. You got the floor, bro. I want to hear what you got. I know you.
Yeah, I'm just going to turn the speaker off. But basically, I knew it was fake since day one, the crying that they was doing while the mother was on the news. I already knew they was foreigners. So once you see foreigners and national coverage and more than likely a missing something, it's more than likely fake. And I heard Ms. Crenshaw ask last night on her live why they think they use foreigners, and the reason they use foreigners is because once they complete whatever part of the agenda or operation that they are here to complete, they can send them back to their country. You understand? So that's why they use foreigners. Like, we believe Kanika is not in this country no more, but she is still alive, and that's why they use foreigners. And foreigners are also harder to track. You understand? You could tell that they're foreigners because nobody's gonna hold back a story like this knowing Jolie. You understand what I'm saying? The friends that spoke to her last would have been on the news. Like, it's not the friends like that, but like other friends not prepared for the news, just home people. Like, you know, this is my friend Jolie, just regular amateur people on their post. You don't see that with Kanika. You don't see that with Jolie. You understand? And Americans, we can't keep our mouths closed, because at the end of the day, people got morals and they could be you. So people go out their way once they hear missing. And then, you know, we got two young girls here, allegedly. So they just playing on people's hearts right now. But what they're mainly doing is they're crying wolf. With all these missing girls that they're faking, like we said, people are really getting kidnapped. But not only that, it's sending out, you could get away with murder on these type of women or girls type of subliminal message, I feel.
Now look, check this out. I'm just showing y'all the pictures while he's talking, because I know y'all tired and I just don't want people to just come.
What is their overall agenda is what I'm trying to figure out at this point.
I like to say that overall agenda is just, you know, you can come up with some type of, you know, change some type of laws about, you know.
That's what I mean. That's what I was thinking. But like, I mean, I don't know if it's like a social. What do you plan on the fix? What do you? Oh, he's muted. What do you think about the overall agenda for this is?
The overall agenda is just basically, it's a bad look. It's a bad look for the father. It's a bad look for the mother. and the sister seems careless. So again, we got a demographic of people that are not responding the way people with common sense will respond. So it's kind of reinforcing the stereotypical uneducated, even though they're professionals, they're still ratchet stereotype, you understand? So I think that's going to always be the main agenda, because these people are never going to have real reactions. And based on not having real reactions, that's, you know, sending out a message to the world that, look, these people are not even sympathetic to their own kind. You understand? Like, look how dumb they are. Why wasn't the father around, or whatever the case may be? And it also sends another message of people being dependent on the state daddy. Because I noticed the feds got involved, and like you said last night, Ms. Crenshaw.
Oh, yeah.
They didn't really put out the Amber Alerts like that or anything like that. And at the end of the day, they could still track Snapchat and all that. Believe it or not, it don't have to be held on a database, but there's other metadata that could be used to track who communicates with who, or when it was sent, or whatever the case may be.
Like, they should have been able to find that girl when they made the phone call.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that was just...
They could read them from the cell phone towers, I believe. You know, not like that, but cell phone towers could relay what cell phones went to those databases of Snapchat. They got ways that they could minus all of that down and get a suspect.
Yeah.
True.
Yeah, could be.
And my mom just texted me, she said, a prior felony assault that was previously unreported is how they're wording this. And I'm like, how is it a felony if it's unreported? And how does a minor...
Stop it, Jay.
How could it be a felony at all for somebody that's only, how old is this kid supposed to be? 17? So are they really going to try to blame this child for a crime that doesn't exist?
Man, the child probably don't even exist. 17-year-olds are speaking about imagination.
Y'all see, I'm trying to talk any kind of way. You done muted me. I'm over here writing.
I'm telling you, if you look at that interview, even without people helping you figure it out, if you watch that interview and don't think something ain't right, something is wrong with you. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's kind of precious tail on that view, but when you twist
it. Look at that reporter's face. She's so satisfied, because at the end of the day, she knows he's been harmed or something. Look at that reporter's face. Holy shit, he's lit. You know that's a man.
I know, look at the way she's looking at him.
She's looking like, I want to suck your dick. I wish she would. Because, you know, she is a man. You know, I don't care what nobody says. That's a fucking thing.
I'm from. To get this story, that's what you got to look at. They couldn't that's use Larry Holmes in there.
Right.
And shout out to Jay All Day. Y'all may not recognize the voice, but that's the voice from Purple Child.
A word?
Oh, you talking about the reporter?
Everybody's a suspect.
What? Wait. Are you talking about the reporter?
You talking about you, Jay.
Oh, that Matt the Night picture?
No, he's talking about the purple child. That's you.
Oh, shit. I ain't getting no damn money for this shit.
Nobody.
I caught it real quick. I said, yo.
That's when you do that long shit. Now look at that.
Can I play that commercial again? Let's play that commercial. I got to find it now. Yeah. Because I always wanted to play that commercial live. I got a reason now.
And then did you see those paragraphs? Did you see those paragraphs I got, Huggy? On that person, those paragraphs on all the reasons I was wrong for my video?
Oh, you've been wanting to play for the longest?
Yeah.
Come on, nigga.
Classic shit. Hold on. What the funniest
part? They are not from here.
They got all of them, yo. They got all them dicks. Hold on. I got all of them.
Yeah.
When the clock strikes half past eight, time to head for the golden lights. It's a good time for the
dinner at McDonald's.
It's does he look like the mask from when Jim Carrey put on the mask?
Where the one at? Oh, is it the one at night? At nighttime.
Golden light. It's my morning place. You are beautiful. It's
man, that was the shit. That was the shit. They had the beautiful.
It was.
That was the shit. Hey, a lot of y'all have no idea when what year that came out. A lot of y'all gotta be at least 30 plus to know about this shit.
Yeah.
Gotta be.
Yeah, he was ballpark. I remember that commercial for us. That's when McDonald's was doing it.
Yeah, when McDonald's was actually.
Oh, I'm sorry, before.
When McDonald's didn't have like four combos and shit. Now we got 20 and shit. 20. Yeah.
Oh, my bad. I wasn't watching the chat.
I didn't see that she was married to this guy when I looked on the profile the other day, but I mean, usually people of West Indian, you know, type of backgrounds, they at least know how to do. She's
wearing
hers. She
doesn't
let go of all
the
roots.
Well, you know what's funny is that she has a sister that's a beautician.
Yeah, but some of the wigs look like she rocking the George Jefferson lace wigs. I'm like, what the heck to the sister? Her sister got them. Oh my god, that what's her name? Tinashe.
Oh,
she got
you know
some wigs with eyebrows out this world. I'm like, what the hell? You can tell she drew them out of anger, anxiety. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, Kamiko, I'm gonna hold him to that.
Huggy, Jen Vaughn has a good, she had a good question. She said, I did a quick last name search for Musa, primarily Egyptian, curious if the Egyptian moral / lifestyle, etc. is part of the Floyd in this case.
It's a Muslim name, and that's probably why he had custody of the girls.
No, Musa is actually, it's an Arabic name.
Yeah,
right.
And it has something to do with French, too.
Yeah,
so. It is an Arabic name. But, and there are also Arabs that are Muslim, or Arabs that are Muslim, obviously, and then there are also people from Africa that are Muslim as well. So, it's
the name. It's the name for Moses. It's the name for Moses. It's actually supposed to be MUSA, yep. But when you add the OUSSA, I guess that's like a. It's like the male correspondent of the name.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You know, like Ibrahim and Musa and Isa is Jesus. And, you know, I'm familiar with that.
My name is Irving. My homie, my
government. I had the school chosen because he was making fun of, you know, Ricky was like, he's a Muslim. And he was making fun of the Arabic language. And I was like, dude, do you know your middle name is an Arabic name? Your name is Rashid.
Oh shit!
Yeah, Rashid. It's actually what was it? What is it called again? What was the animal? Shit, I can't remember the name of the animal. It's got devil horns, and I was like, damn. So that means your mom was the devil. She named you after a fucking animal that's made out of devil horns. I gotta look it up. I forgot what they called it. Rashid.
Ram?
A gazelle.
Oh, a ram?
Yeah, it's a gazelle. And I said, damn, she named you after a gazelle with devil horns. That means your mom was the devil. You know what I'm saying? So,
well,
You should have said making fun of Arabic language, and your middle name is Arab.
My whole name is.
What is she showing on her screen right now?
Oh shit! Let me go back over here. I'm sitting up. We playing with the Mac tonight. Let me go back over here. Oh. Right, we back on here now.
Everything that I was seeing on it, but
no yellow tape.
This is supposed to be when they found it. I don't see no tape, but I see they're supposed to be in hazmat suits. Some of them.
What's up with the yellow tape thing? Why have what like?
I guess this is what it's supposed to be. These are just markers, but this just to let them know where to go. But when you find a process a crime scene, you have to coordinate off so that it won't be contaminated by any outside interference. So when they're supposed to block up everything, any area that may have to do with the crime scene, so that they can get footprints and or find evidence and all kind of stuff. And this was just proof that you see how the mother had this iPhone, but she didn't know anything about how iPhones work. And then it didn't say that she worked anywhere except for what the, I noticed that Ashanti Billy and the two sisters here, Jolie and Jhené, they work at the Krusty Krab, quote unquote. Everybody from the Nika situation, they work at True Religion.
All those kids though, if you go into their Facebook friends, all their friends or whatever from Colorado, they all say that they work at the Krusty Krab. It's just something that a group of those friends did.
Yeah,
I don't find that.
Yeah,
bad.
Yeah, I noticed that. I'm gonna ask my niece because I'm trying to figure out the correlation. You know, because what are the odds?
That's just a real place.
It's a real restaurant. Colorado. No, not in Colorado. It's in Virginia.
It's a restaurant in Colorado.
It's in Virginia in
our
D.C. area.
It's a
man, baby.
Well, all their friends in Colorado, though, say that they work at the Krusty Krab also. If you go onto their friends' Facebook pages, they say it, too.
Oh, okay.
And those kids live in Colorado.
Oh, wow. I had noticed Ashanti really had it on hers. It's just weird that, some of these kids that are going missing... And and it's like after their situation is over with, like Ashanti Billy's mother, she's posting nothing but
Detroit on her shirt now. Who? What is it? Why does this lady always feel the need to have a city on her shirt?
I know, right? Because she's trying to prepare, I guess.
Yeah, her husband's from Detroit, and she's supposed to be from Colorado, and she's supposed to be from Virginia, and Texas. And
was that supposed to be her mom?
She's supposed to be from all of this shit.
Was that supposed to be
her mom? See the one picture? Yeah.
Okay. Oh, Deborah. So Deborah's the mom, not the sister.
Deborah's the fucking mom.
It says.
I think Deborah's playing parts too.
Mother's Day. Yeah.
The other sister has Deborah as the sister because I was getting ready to write down sister.
Me. Yeah.
Yeah. But but Tinashe. I just saw it on Facebook. I think I took a picture of it.
What, the singer?
that's how you pronounce her name? What's
up with these names?
The one with them upside down Nike checks. The eyebrows.
like the new pool?
Yeah, basically. How do I find these?
But the other sister, though, that we were looking at, Huggy, is Dorothy's not her mom, though, right?
They all look like they were sisters. They probably just got different daddies.
Well, that's how it go, different daddies is the way of life in most cases. Oh. Mama's babies, daddy's babies.
She could be off on the 11th floor for real though.
Say it again, who? The 11th floor. Hey, push out. We saw in that criminal part, it did say male.
It what?
Late out of summer. The millennium version.
Yeah, if I come across the number 9,
she's like a old school porno
one more
star.
Time,
that's Robin Harris.
13.
She's like a 70s porno star.
Yeah, right. What is going on with this picture? And who is who's in the very center? Who's that supposed to be? Which girl is that? Yeah,
Jhené has a nose ring. So this is supposed to be what's her name? Jolie. What's his tongue thing look like?
Yeah, Clinton basically trying to say something. I think something wrong with his mic.
The father been picking these girls since they was young.
Wait, the father? He said the father. I know, right? Father been pimping these girls. So I know. I'm telling you.
Yeah, tattoos, tattoos, piercings. Yeah, a lot of stuff.
Advertising them and shit. Did you see? Notice that all of this training to cry, but there's no tears coming out.
Right.
But see, the dad. Did y'all peep in the beginning? But she was like, she's not in control and all that stuff. And she looked over at the dad. She like gave him the side eye.
Who? Side eye.
Hey, she kind of gave her dad the side eye after she finished speaking for the reporter.
She kind of just looked like end scene.
Yeah, she gave him a look like somebody dropped the ball or something. Where can I? That's what I'm trying to find these. I just saw the live. These things, these what you call it that y'all did.
I mean, let me talk to this lady in the chat, Brooksy. Okay. The case may have been real, but what's up with the parents? Like, do they get along? Because it seemed like the mom was scared of the damn father. That shit was weird. And he the one that seemed like he was just so happy. She seemed like she was the one that was afraid.
If this was real, the father would be in jail already.
You said what now?
If it was real, the father would be in jail.
The father would be in jail.
Are we talking about the later. We talking about Shanti Billy's case. Yeah. Somebody mentioned that.
Y'all know that this whole I'm gonna wait to find out, because I don't want to pay for nobody's background check. I ain't got time for all that. But how can I find public records? Because I always try to put it in, and I can't. So I'm like looking at the names and stuff. So I'm gonna look them up in Facebook, because I just saw your other live. So I took the screenshots of what y'all background check y'all did, but I don't know how to go in. You know what I'm saying?
You don't know how to do what?
No, every time I try to search, I get these third-party advertisements for public record and stuff. Like, how y'all did the background check right here
because
with the family?
Because I have paid subscriptions for, like that one. Oh, the one that I use is, like, $20 a month, so it's called People Looker.
Oh, shit, that's good. That's better than the one I had. It cost me
$99. Yeah, People Looker is a good one, and it gives you, and what I like about that particular app is that it gives you information. Okay, like it'll have information inside of her. Like for every phone number, I can click on every phone number, and it will give me more information linked to that phone number. For every email, so right. That's how I was able to get her entire LinkedIn and her Indeed, which had her entire resume on there. Because it was attached to her email address. So that's how I do my background check. I go through every single thing connected to that person in every way I can. Right. And then I know what I'm working with. And that's how I know she has absolutely no affiliation with Memphis in her life whatsoever.
Right. Now, I did see her on her profile. And I saw her on her profile, but I'm not going to use y'all screenshots. But that's how, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
I can go and look at Facebook.
That's an app that has called People Looker. That's a really good one. Just in general.
People what? You said it was People what?
Oh, People Looker.
Oh, thank you.
Ben Verified is good too.
Oh, it is? Okay.
Mm-hmm. They pretty much give you the same information. So if I would get one or the other,
okay.
Not spend money on both, because I have both and I don't know why.
Yeah, but I'm like, well, at least I can look the names up in social media or something.
And Intellius, that's a good one too. It's I like use that one. I use all those. Spokio is a good email reverse search. There's a lot of good like things if you want to search. Like, there's different ones that are good for pictures, some are good for email searches, whatever. I would look
okay, motherfucker. You.
You're welcome.
That's what I would use, because I need to know. I don't know what's going on with this one here, because, I mean, she's supposed to have been with a Muslim, right?
Who's this guy?
This, I don't know. This is in her MySpace. But this is her MySpace.
Oh, that's her MySpace. We were just talking about that earlier, and I hadn't even looked at her MySpace yet, but I gotta check this out. Oh, this is one too. Oh, let me see the girls. Pictures of the girls.
Okay.
Oh, that's okay. That picture of the girls. No, the picture of the girls with the with. Okay, with the here, X out of that so I can show you. Okay. It's the picture with the furry jackets right there.
Oh, okay.
On the top. Now that picture, that particular picture, if you go onto Jeanne's Facebook page, somebody writes in French underneath that. She's like calling that. There's a lady that keeps writing in their older pictures, talking about like calling them her babies and stuff like that.
Ah,
I brought it up in
like
my
Sasha and Aaliyah, Sasha and Obama situation.
And the lady that's doing that, she's in Africa.
See? Like, look, remember what they said with the president, like how he was barring the children? Like, we got the children on credit for the presidency thing.
So, and then I find it really odd that when the girls, okay, like if I have, okay, like for example, these pictures are on the mom's old ass MySpace, right? So if I'm gonna make a Facebook page, like my daughter, she has social media, she's not gonna go onto my shit and pick old pictures of herself and start putting those on her page, like to start a story, like to start like that, to make a credibility for her page. It doesn't make any damn sense. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yep, you're right. And then doesn't it seem like the same pictures, like how the profiles are set up, are kind of like almost like the Kanika case?
Can you see the dates? Can you see the dates on these? I want to see like the does it give us dates of when this is supposed to be supposedly uploaded? On Facebook, MySpace, it usually would at least give. This is so old. This makes me feel so old. It's all MySpace.
I'm trying. I might have to create a profile, just so I can, kind of see. Because
it says photos. If you put, I think like on photos.
Sometimes
it gives you an option to. Who is that?
That was supposed to be Serena. Or was it Simon?
Right. No,
what they call him.
Right there. No, not her. Was she twerking?
That's supposed to be her. Yeah, back pocket. She escaped from the freezer. You know, back pocket pose like, they take a picture, bitch. Hell no.
Hey, where does her MySpace about? Where does it say that she's from? Bet you it don't say Memphis.
Check out what Cuba said. I said that earlier, man. Kershaw said, I bet you the damn twin daughter probably gonna end up a singer, popular. Yeah. Yep.
I know. Yeah, I said that too. And they're if you go onto their page from the time that they were little, it's like they were being prepped to be singers. And who is that? Those are
friends. Lanisha Cope.
But if you go into her, doesn't say where she's from?
That's what I'm trying to click on. Oak Hill, Virginia. That's where this picture's at.
Is that? Yeah. No, that's where it's saying that she's from. That's where she has her. Mm-hmm. That's where she has her page from, right? Oak Hill, Virginia, right there.
Yep. That's where.
What an odd.
Let's see who's over here.
Thought pocket.
New flavor.
Oh, and Kara said with that video, do you have that video where she's like, we're the Sorrells? We're not. Uh-huh. Yeah, there's a YouTube video where they're being boys instead
of. I got the video.
Yeah, Planet of the Fakes has it for sure. Can you play?
Oh, the like the duality world. Folks, that's what the dad was doing, a lot of
stupid
light on that smiling. I'm like,
no. The ocean girl. So now she's just gonna be the ocean girl.
That other girl is somewhere. She's probably chilling with the nigga.
Let me share Planet of Fake screen. You feel the play of Planet of Fake?
Yeah.
Okay. I got you on Planet of Fake.
Comes on like after this.
Okay.
audio.
All the pimping him.
Right.
Audio was fake because at the end of the day, just like Kanika entering the hotel in the dark side, shit like that don't make sense. So they setting us up for the fake shit. This shit right here was setting us up for the fake shit. Just, you know, I guess this is when they first got in the dad's company.
Yeah.
He's trying to make money off of them, make them YouTube stars. Because what else is there to do with your kids? You know what I mean? So here they go right here.
This kind of like symbolizes something. You see what I'm saying? They're playing like boys. It's kind of like you can look at it like deception.
I'm trying to figure out what male role model did they get this from? Because look, they obviously supposed to be playing
like boys. The dad's
name is Sorrell. Yeah. It's Sorrell. Maybe I keep feeling like the mother.
Oh, you hear that, Kiara? The dad's name is Sorrell, but it's spelled completely different.
Spelled it C-Y-R-E-L.
Yeah, he spelled it like, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, his name is Sorrell.
Because me and Kiara were like, who the hell is Sorrell?
when Mac the Knight asked him in the interview, he said Sorrell. I'm sorry, I can't. King Joffy Joffa.
Hey, Black Kiwi just said, what if these are Keith Kanika's real younger siblings?
They probably went to Kanika Challenge.
Yeah,
but they don't look like her. They look like Obama kids.
You know, Obama, he borrowed, what's his name, kids.
Nesbitt? Marty Nesbitt?
Yeah, I knew about that a long time ago, way before this game.
Yep. And that little girl right there, that she's in Colorado.
Yeah, they from Colorado, but they came from across the water, too.
And keep in mind, y'all, a lot of people don't know, in Colorado, they got a lot of underground bases out there, too, underground cities all over Denver. They even got in the airport letting it be known, yeah, we got underground cities right here where y'all at.
Who dressed the girls like this? I know the father did.
Right.
Right.
Probably did. Probably went broads, too.
Clearly, he had to have. Mama wasn't around.
And then they just grown.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Then they fell off of social media for like.
This
like,
is acting what? Right here. Zane is acting.
She's Sorrell right now.
She doesn't have control.
Exactly.
Like, she said that.
Also, you gotta remember, she said the same thing that Andrew Holmes said, that Masonic term, and the lawyer Larry Rogers said. She's trying to find her way to a charger. That's a giveaway. That was a Masonic term.
Find her way.
Yeah, find her way.
It's like, how do you know where she's trying? What she's trying to like? Wait, what?
Trying to find her way
to a charger. She's trying to find it. This is the line that the sister used. Her phone is dead, and she's trying to find her way to a charger. She said it just like that.
Yeah, she
but
did.
But you notice
all
the
slow and crazy looking.
The man in the moon, when she said phone died, that's when she started talking all crazy.
Yeah,
this isn't like her.
Just played the video where they said the Sorrell.
The phone shouldn't have been dead, though, if she'd been in the house all that time.
They just played that video. I'm looking at it now. But yeah, I'm gonna tell you, bro, this shit is like weird, so. Weird. Like these videos be out there. Just imagine how many kids we see, and we be like, 10 years from now, we're gonna hear a story about one of them being dead. And it's all fucking fake.
I was so angry last night when I went live. I was so irritated. I was like, I'm tired of this shit.
Yeah. I was thinking about doing a reaction channel with me and my son. I thought about it like, man, I don't even want him on the internet.
Get on the internet when he turned 18. This is where, you know, he's responsible for himself. And at the end of the day, he'll get to learn a lot of lessons from people that's not 18 that's going to get the shit
right.
in there.
Right. I know. Amira, my daughter, wants to be on, like, YouTube and stuff like that, like, so badly. I'm like, no.
I thought about that. Like, that's why I haven't done it, because my second channel is wide open. I can do shit like that now. I don't even want to do it. You know what I mean? I don't even like being on YouTube, really, unless I'm teaching people shit and just having fun. You know what I mean? Because I always been the type to just put some shit up. Just
the mother's fake. Straight foreigner. Y'all can't look at her and tell she's a foreigner.
A long time ago, and then I kept thinking of your voice, but you'd be like, they're not from here.
I was saying that. Nah, she look Haitian to me. Not Haitian like that, but I give, yeah, you know, I'll give her a light-skinned Haitian.
Hey, the sister is Haitian all day. She damn, she from Florida.
Yeah.
An Haitian girl, she Haitian.
Yeah, they not giving foreigners like that national coverage. They not doing it. Because foreigners keep track of the kids.
She's either Nigerian or sometimes Haitian, because when they pronounce the children's name, they say it like they're speaking Creole almost. Like they tried, like they used to speak Creole, you know, just off camera.
Well, one of the people that I found, I commented on the kids' Facebook pages from like years and years ago, was Haitian.
Yeah.
But so why would they not do a better job of covering that shit up?
Why would you can't they cover it up when you're using foreigners?
Did you see the picture on her
like,
Facebook?
Why don't they just take that shit off the fucking Facebook pages? You know what I mean? Like, why would you leave it out there?
It
like,
may not be true. They may be just to throw you off like all these fake Kanika pages.
This is the thing about the work is that they know the average American individual is dumb. They know that the average majority of Black American people are dumb too. So if you get
people are dumb, they're actually just busy, man. You got to realize people work 40 hours a week. Then you got to spend time with social life, kids and all that. So they know people not dumb. People just preoccupied with surviving.
And a lot of times when it comes to what the media tells people, they're just trusting. They're not pre-programmed to
question. That's what I said. I said that you watched 1,000 people share the local story of this woman being mentioned from here, and nobody's questioning it, but I'm the only one.
Yeah, nobody in your town? Okay, on your like in your town, on the news article, can't people like comment on it?
Yeah.
And nobody commented on it?
Everybody. There was about 70 comments. I'm the only one questioning. Why is people saying this girl from here and can't nobody verify it?
Did you comment on it?
Yeah. And of course, it's 14 hours later, no response. I put a picture up, and you know my fucking friends list is stupid. I put a picture up, I put a post up, nobody responded to it. Does anybody know this girl? She's born in 81. I'm pretty sure she went to somebody's high school. Somebody verified. Somebody got a yearbook? Anybody? I know she didn't go to my school. You know, the city is too fucking small. This is 600,000. This is one big circle. It breaks off to Nashville, Mississippi, and Arkansas. So it's not that huge. So everybody knows somebody is.
I think it's Potomac Mall. That mall project that I was talking about the other day, that mall is full of Africans. Full of in Virginia. And it's a very rich looking mall, too. But that's close by where this girl lives, in the Alexandria area. And then one of them on their Facebook, they have that they're from Alexandria, and the other one has Woodbridge. But I don't know if y'all seen on Sarita's Facebook. It's a picture of, I guess this guy is his dad, with the little triangle mustache. And it says, Happy Father's Day. But all the lettering is upside down, except...
Oh, yeah,
Kieran
showed that to me last night.
And I said, well, if you're used to writing in a different language, then you would mess up everything like that. But they didn't do it with the, you know, Mother's Day one. So I'm sitting like, what was distinct, though, was that the P's were upside down and the Y's, it looked like triple sixes.
Oh, she had a foot in the park?
What?
They have a foot. Somebody says she'll put another the face, the foot they found in the park.
Come on.
That's an inside joke.
I'm about to say they still playing with your feet.
Oh. Oh my goodness, this is crazy. Okay. But she, yeah, she definitely wasn't, she wasn't from the leftist of the day.
Lying bitch.
And so you
asking
the question, they were like,
"Lance, yo, so Miss J, yo, did you get a screenshot of her timeline before she changed it?
That was the only thing. I'm gonna look though, because
Yeah, please do, because it did not. I swear to. Oh, Planet of the Fakes, do you?
I want a screenshot of what?
Look, okay, the mom just recently changed her Facebook up. She hid her friend list. It wasn't hid before. She changed her city to say just Memphis. It did not fucking say that. It did not say that. It said Texas, and then I think it said, like, when you went into the about that, like, Colorado or something was in there, too. But now it says Memphis.
This one right here definitely says.
But do you happen to have a screenshot or a video that
she... I never checked her mother's Facebook or none of that. Like, I'm the type, once I find out it's fake, I kind of just wait for more evidence to come with fakeness. But I didn't really look up the mother because it was obviously fake with the crying and news. It just was too fake for me. It was too fake.
Yeah.
But I didn't want to get into
another
mother.
She messed up. She said it from my tweet. That's why she was crying. I'm like, ain't
you got
a mother?
Then the stepfather spoke up. I said, oh, no. Like, you know what I mean? Like, who is the stepfather?
The stepfather.
You understand?
Did you see the video of the stepfather when he's talking about Jolie and he's smiling ear to ear the whole time? It was like disturbing.
Yeah, he does that every time.
That nigga got a post where he wrote yesterday. He was like, "My wife gone for a week. I guess this is my dinner every day or some shit."
LOL.
She lost her. She allegedly lost her daughter. He makes a post like that.
Yeah, don't believe me. Go on Eric Hill's shit. It's a post he just put up about a plate.
Plate?
Yeah. I'm telling you, she looks super foreign, man. I'm telling you.
Can y'all see the picture? Look at the letters. That everything else is upside down. Who does that?
Damn.
Except for the B and the Y, look like triple sixes.
Oh. God damn. I done it again. Another sign for niggas.
It's going crazy, you can tell.
Get out of here.
Yeah. I know, it's just going on, like, stretch this way.
She need to get out of here, man, for real. I can't do no more of these scripts on the D mothers, man.
These eyelashes and these freaking wigs drive me freaking bananas. I can't
see what you did with.
The eyelashes are very wide. Well, Moses had to say,
Reread what you did with Jolie.
I'm just saying, what's up with the father's eye, man? That door story is bullshit.
Yeah, that centipede on his eye.
People need to get that medical.
It's not a regular door. He went into a car door now.
Now
how you run into a car door? Come on.
He was rushing when he heard the news, and he made sure to have his hospital bracelet on in the interview.
Oh yeah, this is it's gonna be mother.
Wait a minute, hospital bracelet on? When did you got? Wait, what?
Remember, yeah, you didn't know that.
She got mother was in the hospital too.
Wait.
So they use the hospital as alibi.
He went to the hospital because he had to get stitches under his eye, and then he got on the next plane or whatever to get out of town.
What the hell? So he left him at home alone?
He left right. No, no guys, wait, Uncle Christopher had him.
The story is that supposedly their uncle was watching them. This is what I was talking about last Chris. Night. I don't know if you saw it from the beginning, but I said the uncle is supposed to be watching these fucking girls. So at no point in time after she left was he like, Jolie, girls, hey, like, well, at what point in time did this babysitting ass uncle realized there was nobody for him to babysit, or only one of the two that there for him to babysit? On top of that, the story, this is how else you know that the story is bullshit. They said that the girls were planning on going to spend the night at a friend's house. If that was the case, why would they fucking need a babysitter? Why do you need a babysitter?
I'm just saying, you got 16-year-old daughters. You're not letting your brother babysit. Who's really letting their brother babysit teens? Come on.
Right. Everything about this story makes no sense.
Come on, man. They're not Americans.
If nobody was home, what car was she walking past in the driveway? Because clearly the dad injured himself on his car when he was wherever he was.
We not buying that car injury. Somebody
I was like, nigga, what type of door did you hit?
You see all these people here?
I'm thinking basically the father, like, not sold Jolie, but he turned a blind eye to her abduction for whatever reason. Maybe he got gambling problems, whatever. But I think the father got certain injury. Because that injury is ridiculous right there. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, yeah.
And Mama T was in the hospital as an alibi on the day Kanika disappeared too. So we got similar situations. Parents in hospitals. You don't understand? Mother in the army. Once you hear military, you got to realize the military was involved with Kanika's as well. But not only that, what was the other girl named? Billy Ashanti, I believe. Didn't they say a veteran took her?
Well, we don't even know. We never even got like an update on that, did we? Like, was anyone arrested?
Yeah, that suspect. The suspect was a retired veteran.
But is he actually arrested? Like, could I look him up? His court records?
Yeah, you probably could look him up. I did a short video on it on one of these channels I got private, but he should still be in there. But if that was fake, it's gonna get swept under the rug too.
Yeah, it's what that shit under the rug.
I know, right?
But you can still look at her friends that are following her, even though she has her list blocked. These people, none of them look American at all.
They're not.
Those are not her friends. Those are just people. That's
the followers.
People who are following.
Yeah, followers, and that's what I'm saying. It's kind of hard to weed through.
Yeah, I say so even though she has the friends,
that could be like I could go on and follow her right now. It doesn't mean that she accepts my friend request. I'll just be following her. So those are people that are trying to be her Facebook friend, but she hasn't accepted it yet.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. They're just followers, but they don't look American. None of them, just by all these followers, they don't look American. You click on any of these people, none of them, but she doesn't look American. Just pick another random one. It's like
that, y'all. Look at Bianca Malone. She might be American. That sound like an American name.
What's that? No, I'm saying the people, you know how they change a lot of their names up, too.
Yeah.
Nope,
she's not American.
Going to profile.
She's not American.
They put this shit throughout the whole profile and shit.
You could tell Americans because we don't take submissive pictures like that even when we're trying to look passive. As Americans, we walk around like we're old in this motherfucker. Foreigners don't walk around like they old. They walk around like they got what they came for and they appreciate it. And that's what I get from a lot of these people.
There's an Antonia up here, and there's somebody with the last name Stanton. I'm just like, this is weird. Like, the odds, there's a lot of Brianna's and stuff like that.
They might be even paid for, who knows?
Yeah, you know they gotta pay them. All PSYOPs are funded.
Go back to their country.
Crisis, they fund crisis actors, they fund crisis riot makers. All this shit. It could be, it could be 100 people out there protesting for peace.
Oh, that was a Breonna Jolie Black up there.
What?
Yeah, one said Breonna Jolie Black. What else I was going to say? The reason you won't be able to find information because people like Gray Hughes, the search engine optimizers, when you put in fucking Musa Jolie or any of these motherfuckers, they fuck around and have real pages all the way to the back of the internet. And have their fake information in the front like they did with Kanika. So you gotta thank Gray Hughes and people like that for that shit.
Hey, Gray Hughes here.
So say she accidentally walked in that park herself.
Maybe she just went in the freezer and died in hypothermia.
God, Jolie went to that park herself.
Look, you are far more precious than jewels, Gregory, Peyton, and KJ. Look. A purple and a green heart too.
Yep. Oh. I told you certain things stick out.
Yeah, it's like there's so many Brianna's. There's an Antonia here. There's a freaking somebody with the name Stanton.
Who is that Cyril Hill? That's not how the name spelled.
Where?
at the top of that page, it says Siree Hell with the two girls there. All the way at the top, the profile picture. That's not how his name is spelled. Yeah, it's not spelled like that.
Sarita? No, that's Sarita.
Oh, Sarita. Oh, all right.
Are you
talking about Sarah? Why she got that picture there? Because I guess she's giving a memorial.
Oh,
or is that another girl?
What they did, they changed it. They called themselves Sarah.
This was the picture the other day.
They spelled their name in a combination of the,
yeah,
the mom and the dad's. Okay.
Yeah.
I see it now.
It's corny, I guess.
Yeah. It's corny.
That's a foreign family right there.
Before she changed it.
Yep. Look at the sons in the back. Look at those hairlines. Those are foreigners.
this something's done here. Something's going on with this lion back here. Look at it.
Okay.
Look at the
cow.
This is not the house.
Okay.
Look
at how happy they are. They Cosby happy. They're hugging.
I looked up
her sister right there. Is there only one sister?
No, she's the other one's right here.
Right where? Where?
Right here. There's always one with some headphones on the phone.
No, obviously. I'm talking about this picture that you were just on. The family.
This one right
the,
here?
The family one. This one. No. You passed it.
Okay. This is not. This is Sade. And this is the one with the blonde braid. But with braids, you can take the.
I don't like the mother. She looks sneaky.
Yeah.
Yes, you do.
No, the family picture. The picture of the whole group of family.
That's what, the only other family picture I was on was this one.
Right, that's the one I'm talking about.
Oh, you don't. It must have been lagging because you were saying no. So that's
wait, but what, which one. Picture? So where's the girl? So where's the sister in that picture?
This is Jolie, and this is John A.
That ain't John
A. Right here.
That's not John A.
It might be though. She just got a different hairdo. Look close. It might be. I'm looking close. It might be. She just looked growner. She looks older than 16. Sorry.
So if you're saying that that's such so new of a picture, why would they say that she had blonde braids in her hair at the time then?
No. I wasn't talking about this picture. I want to say
no.
That's
the same outfit. That's the same day.
No, it's not the same outfit. I was using a different picture.
No,
I said it's all a different.
The red plaid shirt with the headband.
Right.
And the puppy.
And the jacket. But I didn't see the pants though. She could be. This could be another day that she had this on. You know what I'm saying? I don't know what day she had this on, but I know the other one. The fly. She's in the same. All I can see is from the top, the jacket.
Yeah, hairs in a half bun, headband on, red plaid shirt, puppy fucking jacket. Nothing matching.
Yeah, it's the same picture as in the flyer.
Right. But if you're saying that these pictures were uploaded like that they were like in January or whatever, then what my point is that the father claimed that for Christmas, quote unquote, she got the blonde braids, so she should have had blonde braids in this picture. There is one picture of her looking older with blonde braids. There is one, but it's on the stepfather's page. That's the only picture where they look older and they have blonde braids in their hair. Like right there. Like there she is right there with the blonde braids.
But with braids though, I can build wigs from scratch and I use nice braid hair. You can take these braids down quick. This is nothing to take these down. That was Christmas, and then we're already going to February.
So you're saying that the father's completely lied, that they're, I mean, I don't, not that I believe them anyways, but you're saying that they lied about what type of hair she had at the time?
No, not at the time. I'm saying, what I'm understanding you saying is, he said she had the blonde braids, and I heard him say that around Christmas. She got blonde braids.
No,
Christmas.
He said, yeah, and that she still, when she went missing, she still had the blonde braids in. That's
right, but I wasn't disputing. I know you're saying that because of the pictures that I was showing from the flyer and in the kitchen, it's a different color hair. And he's saying that she had blonde braids, and you're saying it can be possible because her hair was blonde. But I'm saying that you can easily take these braids down in a heartbeat.
Yeah, I'm just trying to figure out the timeline of these photos, basically, because I don't know, none of it makes
sense. It's January 2nd. That's 9 days.
Yeah, this is the other one that I was showing y'all said. 16th and the 21st.
Right. I agree.
That's 11 days.
So she should have had, according to them, that's another lie then. Because according to them, she should have had blonde braids.
But that's necessarily because you can take braids down, you can put them in one day and take them out the next. They're not.
I get that.
These don't take long at all.
Yeah, the family said it.
The family said she had blonde braids. That because she had the same braids.
Right, I know what this is.
So that's just another lie then. They didn't even have that, which would make sense because that security footage, I said she doesn't even have blonde hair. Whoever that was walking out on that security footage.
It was the sister probably. That's why she wore that hoodie to hide the fact of the hair. They're leaving her country. And the sister's acting like her just to act dead, just like the fake Kanika, but the sister's playing the fake Kanika in this shit.
But this one right here, when you
were
saying the outfit, I'm thinking the whole thing. I'm just
like, shit, crazy. Twins don't separate like that.
They lied throughout that whole interview because even the mom, she couldn't even figure out how iPhone works, but she's using an iPhone. You see what I'm saying? That's what, like, that's what I'm pointing out. So many different things in the video because
the year of purpose is a symbol right there. That's subliminal. You see how it's in purple like that? Yeah, that's subliminal right there. That year of purpose shit. That purp, you notice purple, purpose. I'm telling you. Piece of shit, yeah. I mean, you could throw codes and shit like that. Believe it or not, find out what school they went to, because we're finding out a lot of Kanika and her friends went to Masonic type school type shit. They didn't go to schools. They wasn't in this country.
They wasn't in this country.
Last time they went to school was,
they went to
Skyview in middle school. He said they went to Mount Vernon, but on their page, they never went to Mount Vernon.
This one is January 16th. That's just the posting, but when they took the picture, I don't know. And then I know Wilson and Logic, he has, I think he got some type of software where he can download straight from the profile, and then he can look at when it was possibly like uploaded, or you know, actually like the date it was taken.
It will tell you the date it was uploaded, but not the date that the picture was taken. You know?
No. He can look at the properties of that picture. He because he told me, he said don't take screenshots of them because when I take the screenshot, it's going to add another filter or layer onto the picture, and then it's going to look as if I am the original owner of the picture. But he has software that he can download straight from Facebook. And then he can look at the properties and look at the original date and stuff like that. He said he had software. Because I was working on this whole thing with him. And he told me, I heard him saying it before. But as far as the properties, like, that's how we found out what Tazande looked like and where she was at and what her name was on Facebook. Because she was showing her files and she went into her properties. And so G and all of us, we would just take a screenshot and writing different things down, but then we were able to narrow down who she was on Facebook.
Play in the face, you missed it. Crying and shit. Well, you ain't missing it. I posted up and unlisted it and sent it to everybody who want to hear it. And she was,
who was crying?
She
got
But they accepted her right back in. She's more famous than ever now. That's why I don't mess with this community. Because the more you lie, the more you accept it, and the more fame you get. And I'm not willing to do that.
I want nothing to do with that fucking lady.
Hell no.
I was trying to ask the questions to moderate all the questions from the chat on the Fed's channel. And she was like arguing with G. She was like, let me talk to the girl. I'll deal with the girl.
Yeah, because you were letting her just say whatever she wanted to say. And she
right,
really,
but he unfair to answer, ask her the questions.
That's what she does.
But I never dealt with Tay to, you know what I'm saying, just start arguing with her. So he wanted me to just ask her the questions from the chat to keep it organized for him. Because then once her and G got on the panel, he asked her questions, that tension came up. And so he wanted to make sure to get all the questions out. Because
he wanted to show so that he didn't want to scare her away. But everyone's patience at that point in time was just like done with the lady. I mean, because she does the same shit every fucking time. She'll come in and she'll try
technical
to.
Difficulty.
What she was trying to do was get exposure because she started up a new channel and she has to get 100 subs before she could even go live. So that she was basically just using everyone's platform to cause a shit show and spread more lies until she could go live herself.
And then, you know, y'all, you don't have to do that anymore. They still doing all that 100 sub stuff. YouTube changed their policies around. It's only been almost a month.
Well, that's, she even said it herself, like that she, you know, I just can't. So she was under that impression.
Yeah, they paying attention. They busy changing profiles and going up in people's chat, threatening kids and shit. I seen a big ass cat on my damn my subscribers thing. I said, oh hell no, I hit the block thing so quick.
Which one is it that has the worst skin? Because one of them, her skin isn't as clear.
Look like Jolie.
Well, this is Janae because she got the nose ring. But this is Jolie.
Yeah.
And then she got, you know.
Because I feel like, yeah.
Well, I tell you what, I really enjoyed this. I have to go, well, not look for it. Like I said, I don't have to look for a job to get me a job in the next 5 hours. And by the time I get done, either I might just pop up on a damn friend of a home, or I might call. You know what I'm saying? I might just call because I can get more clarity by a phone call. I just want to touch bases and see him. And oh, he actually pointed at a book and showed me what he showed me. So he was for real. So I just wanted to see that. See how comfortable he was. He's real comfortable or whatever.
And so, that is so insane to me that they're really gonna have someone, they actually have a funeral in, yeah, about to happen in Memphis.
That was quick as hell.
Yeah. But if anything, it's not gonna be an open casket. If they do, it's gonna be some shit. They come up with some kind of way to say, you know, hey, it's gonna be.
I'm gonna put some stuff up tomorrow too, because my mom is overseas and she sent me some information right now. And according to what they're saying over there, is that the police, that the boy, that they have surveillance or some kind of video of the boyfriend assaulting her, and that's why he was arrested on the 18th.
But
so I gotta look into this.
The one that's not real though.
I'm not saying that it is.
I feel what you're saying.
I'm just letting you know that it's a contradiction. So yeah. I'm gonna look into that because she sent me some links too, and I was like, what?
Because everybody really wants something. Just like they said, the Tolliver dude was the one that was going to jail, and then it was Monifa. Mm-hmm. They want something. They want anybody to go down. Yeah, that's all he did. They had tracked down where he was living. I'm like, man, this man ain't done nothing to nobody.
Yeah.
It's fake.
He didn't do nothing. And I said that on his live earlier today. He had the nerve to tell me, shut up, OG. I was tweaking because he likes this. I'm an accident murderer reputation guy.
What? He plays off that because he know that's what people think of him.
Gangsta persona, throw a couple of gang signs, they think you killed Kalinka, and this is how you know the shit is fake and people in Chirac know it's fake, because at the end of the day, you gotta realize, it's not about who wants to kill you when you make it or anything or famous without money or anything. It's not about that. It's about who allows you to be killed. You know what I mean? A lot of people think you get money and then people come to kill you. Nah, it's red lights on you. But people slowly and gradually take those lights off of you. And they turn green one day and then you gotta hold yourself down. With Tolliver Herman, obviously somebody got a lot of red lights up to the point where he did money to be going live and, you know, stuff like that. And that's another thing to let you know it's fake. Because the streets ain't controlled by nobody when it's real stuff like that occurring. Because it's gonna be somebody that don't get the memo that just handles their business, you know what I mean? And you don't see that with the Kanika case. You're not even gonna see that with this, you know what I mean? Like, I don't understand how fathers could go to the police before doing their own investigation and research. You know what I mean? My daughter wouldn't be talking. If I had a 6-year-old daughter and her twin sister was missing, my daughter wouldn't be talking because I would have got all the truth out of them already. Come to me. You understand what I'm saying? She's a 16-year-old girl. Come to me. That's how I knew that shit was fake.
Yeah. Wow.
But think about a 16-year-old girl and they're supposed to be twins. I had a twin girlfriend for 15 years. They tell each other everything. You understand what I'm saying? So the fact that she was going to meet a guy without her sister, that's a red flag too.
Mm-hmm. Right.
It takes a video of her.
Right. She just has no idea.
She would have took her sister's phone if it was that day.
Come on. Mm-hmm. And then they were trying to say that they didn't know that they didn't. She didn't even know what the password is. Her sister don't know her password, and they have no idea.
messages turned green and all that. That's just always green. She got an iPhone. Messaging another iPhone user, and she's sitting there with an iPhone in her hand. I'm like, wow, really? Come on, maybe y'all can help me out there. Yeah, all right. What's interesting is that Teresa is in Tennessee right now. Oh shit, huh? Oh really? Teresa in Tennessee? Nah, she's not. That video was old. That video was old. Are you talking about the video I seen where they said she was going through Mississippi and shit?
She's going to go visit you, huh? Charlotte, Tennessee. I don't even want to see Lenore no more.
She looks bad.
She went into a trance, ran out of the house. She's a big dude. I'm still like, nah. I got a big dude, but you gotta be proportioned. Like, fuck out of here. Yep. I told you she was shaved. She has no shape. She shaved like a fucking second. She got worse. Just better stuff though. APO. And AE, when you was on the other live, the APO is it's a military address when you're stationed overseas. So the APO is Army Post Office, and because it's like the main.
That's one of her and all of those addresses. That's the one she stayed at with, I guess, with her husband.
Mm-hmm. And the other one is the AE is Armed Forces Europe. So like that can you can get that address if you're deployed, because I've had several of those at some point. You know what I'm saying? So. When you're down range, you know what I'm saying, you can still get mail and stuff. But you're, you know, you will use that address, whatever the, you know what I'm saying, the main address is, and then it'll be APO, AE, and then the zip code. But it'll go through that main Army Post Office and then get dispersed out. So she could have been stationed in Germany, Italy, or whatever, probably Germany. But at the same time, it could have been a deployment, too.
Crazy.
Well, guys, this has been lovely. This has been nice.
Yeah. I let you go.
I'm turning the fucking fed. I'm about to go to sleep.
I ain't doing no third strip
tonight. Yeah. Well, again, every day, a leg on the show, every day.
I don't think that Ben out of the Pigs does sleep. Hey. Always awake.
Oh, it's popping my neck. And you know, I'm on Central Time. Some of y'all on East Side, but it's 4:18. I gotta be up. I gotta get up at least because I don't want to be up too late. You know how everybody do. They do the lunchtime shit. I gotta get up before 12 and get out here. You know, do applications. Everybody don't have shit online. It's corny as hell. But
I'll walk. Where's Kenny?
Go do an old school opening. Got hired?
Well, that's what Kenny. Somebody look. What? Talking about my son?
No. I think, well, wait. What Kenny?
Oh, you talking about Kenny Martin?
Kenny don't even know what Kenny is.
So some of y'all that don't know, my actual real name is Kenny. So
yeah.
Yeah, like, she said where's Kenny? I think she's talking about my son or whatever.
Right.
It ain't Kenneth Tart for the wee wee and the nee nee and the kiki and PT.
They got dumb people. I remember when Kenneth Tart first hit the scene, people thought they said, yo, you on I forgot what the fucking website. Or they were like, yo, we just found out you was on such and such website. You was at the hotel. Like, I was what?
Like, really? That's two different looking people.
Yeah, and then it's like, Kenneth Tart was his last name. Kenneth Tart is my last name.
Yeah, so you were at the hotel.
Yeah, they were like, you at the hotel? You gang bang? I what? They were like, we need to see what you look like. I was like, fuck you. I'm not showing you what I look like. go back and look at my videos, nigga. Dude, we gotta come up with a new one, Faith. You gotta be like a Riri, what you do with Jody. We gotta do a new one. Riri. You know she be so you ghetto.
I'll
check out her
MySpace too. Look at all this stuff. Fucking I'm still mad about the fact that they came up with, they just made up their own date of death without an autopsy.
They said the 26th, goddamn.
I'm like, what? That's when she died?
And we said no funeral arrangements and the autopsy ain't done. fuck out of it. I'm telling you, they're going to get through with the autopsy. They're going to cremate her. It's going to be a fucking memorial service like that. Watch. Yeah. Is she back at home chilling in Uganda some goddamn well? Well, Samunda, you know, hopping on one foot. Sure. What the fuck she doing?
Damn shirt on.
With no shirt. Well, guys.
It's been nice talking to everybody, though.
Yeah, real nice. We got Planet of the Fakes in here. We got Miss J all day. And we got Miss Crenshaw. Make sure y'all sub to all three. Planet of the Fakes has Planet of the Fakes Extremes. Go to the website. Go to the website. That's how you keep up. Can't go wrong. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Make you a free account. Get on that bitch. Why not? You know what I mean? Yeah. And you know, you got Black Cuban out here. Subscribe to Black Cuban. You got Kiara Hobbs. Subscribe to Kiara Hobbs. Hey, on the real though, let's throw this out there. I just thought, listen, a lot of these people out here want promoting different channels like that. You know what I'm saying? On the real. Yeah. They start doing it when they realize I was doing it. Not saying I'm the only one that do it, but it's a lot of niggas that be sitting back watching me and not criticize them on that shit. Where they talk all this shit about people, they don't put nobody on. They got a lot of people that's right there in their circle.
Yep.
So, yeah, I like what they doing, but be real, you weren't doing it out of generosity. So yeah, so when I see certain people out here that do got channels and shit, I'd be like, just subscribe to everybody. I'm like showing people how to do certain shit because I want to be able to. I sat back for a while just watching people, and I'd be like, I can go over here, I can go over there, and I can see everybody's shit, and I started to observe a lot of shit. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of fake motherfuckers in these crowds too. You know what I'm saying? A couple, it's a couple, two or three fake motherfuckers was watching me tonight. I ain't gonna say nothing. But they could be fake. They could, as long as they be fake, it's cool. Eventually, one day he's gonna end up getting blocked one day. They're gonna be like, what happened? I'll let them sit around like it's cool. You know what I'm saying? Smile at me and all that shit. You feel me?
Maybe y'all don't have time to. The freaks come out at night.
You know what I mean? So, yeah, you know. I can say right now, ain't none of them in here right now. They not in here right now.
Uh-uh. No,
why
are you?
Yeah, goddamn right. But,
you did put a lot of people up there. I was watching you before I came on to YouTube.
Oh, yeah, because I made it a point where when this shit became something, any channel I had, the first and the second and third, man, this shit for everybody.
My name
was No Thank
You
But God Will Do. Then I came on YouTube and just changed it around. At one time, you looked at me and you were
like, all right, no, thank you. Everybody looking like,
ain't
nobody about to say all that
thing. Right. Cause I ain't no selfish dude. You know what I'm saying? So that's just me. You know what I'm saying? I'm the type of nigga. I deal with movies and shit, but I want to teach people, yo, man, you ain't got to pay me. I'm going to show you how to do this. This is how you do it. You do it yourself. Buy shit for me. Here you go. This is what you do. This is how you do it safe. And get you a VPN and all this old shit. Put a nigga on these Android boxes. How to deal with all this shit. You know what I'm saying? So I ain't no selfish dude. You know what I'm saying?
It's a good film, too, when you can do that. Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm just tired. This year, I'm tired of a lot of shit. Niggas gotta know, like, I gave away three of my dogs. Like, I'm tired. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I'm very tired. And I'm like, I could deal with one dog. You know what I'm saying? I ain't got nobody pressuring me. I ain't obligated to no fucking body. You know what I'm saying? I do what I want to do, how I want to do it, whenever I want to do it. I'm not kissing nobody's ass. Like, you know what I'm saying? So, that's just how it is. I mean, they're gonna have to deal with that shit. This YouTube. In the real world, go down like that too. So, hey.
Right.
I appreciate y'all, though. I really appreciate it.
Appreciate you, too.
Hey, and, man, y'all got anything y'all want to say? Y'all can shout yourself out. We can check in, check out. Y'all go ahead. What's up? What y'all want to say?
Shout out to
Jail. Everybody's a suspect.
That's right. I've never seen it. Everybody suspect.
Everybody.
Hey, yeah, I heard that when you sampled it, I was in the car. I was like, oh, look how they made it.
And I think I'm like, if you made this classic, a lot of people ignored that. Yeah.
Everybody's stuck. They narrow it all down. But look at everybody. The one we ain't looking at might be the one that killed somebody. Yeah. I'm going to go subscribe to y'all channels. I know.
Yeah. What'd you say?
So one question before we go. Chosen still ain't found Grandma Gray Screen?
She got that bag of money.
Hey, well, tell Chosen, I got her. Check it in. And I spent half of it.
So your new line, he said Andrew Holmes is Teresa's uncle now. This dude is the worst.
Oh, God. Oh, that's an uncle. That's an uncle.
My mother's brother. This is what he's saying now. I put out pictures of the grandma, but now he's saying that's Andrew Holmes' sister.
I thought Teresa was a man. Which one is it, nigga?
He's the worst.
He said Teresa was a man one day. 1 week, he said that all week. Teresa was a man.
I started looking at it one day. I was like, she could be like a little scratch with like a rerun. So I was like, no.
TT, what you doing with your OD?
Be like a rerun.
Wrong one. That's seven. You meant to go. Alright, Joe. Y'all have a good morning, good evening, good afternoon to where some of y'all in the UK. Shout out. I know some guys out there in Amsterdam. My name is in Australia. I got one in I throw it Brazil. So it's people all over, man. They everywhere. You know what I'm saying? And we got Kanika Valley everywhere too. So yeah, that's real talk. So I'm gonna say taking out. I might sleep on this fucking couch. I ain't gonna make it to the room.
Thank you for watching. Subscribe to the channel by hitting the red subscribe button and then hitting the notification bell. If you have problems receiving notifications, make sure you unsubscribe and then hit the resubscribe button and hit the bell again. Below you have playlists of many things from the past, such as the What's the Business series, the POF Experience series, and the Memory Lane series as well as past Vision playlists. Also, there's two new channels to subscribe to, my son's gaming channel for Life Gaming, and make sure you keep up with everything dealing with Huggy Pacino. This is Huggy Pacino for the Huggy Pacino Effect. Thank you for your support. And if you wish to donate.
Right, we going. What a money reside. What a money reside. What a money reside. What a money reside.
Now that's Huggy Pacino certified.